yourself a paper and get a helmet on. This is indoor lacrosse. The fans, they're the best in sports. They're wacky, they're wild, and most of all, they are loud. They can make you or they can break you.
Going into an arena, whether you come in a home game in front of 16,000 plus in the Philadelphia Spectrum, and you got the Philadelphia Wings logo on your shirt and have the fans going crazy, I mean, that means a lot. It pumps you up. It's a great high.
Playing in Buffalo, it's kind of like going into a house of horrors, I think.
It's loud. The place goes crazy. They got that damn horn that sounds after every goal.
Their fans are good. They're knowledgeable, and you know, they're a little rough on us. So basically, we want to play well to kind of shove it back in their face if we can.
Bring on Philadelphia. We're going for the three-peat. And this man right here is going to make it all happen.
A three-peat is a difficult task for any pro franchise, especially when the opposing team has two twin powerhouses. Imagine if there were two Emmitt Smiths or two Wayne Gretzky's. Or how about two of the Shaq? Well, the Philadelphia Wings have the Gates, perhaps the two best indoor lacrosse players in the world. Identical twins Gary and Paul hope to bring the city of brotherly love the championship ring in 94.
The Gates, feared by many, stopped by few. To stop these guys, you better hold clutch and grab them, or they'll go right to the back of the net. If the Gates have a rival, it's John Tavares, the 1994 Most Valuable Player. To stop him, he must be shadowed. If not, he and the Bandits may steal another title. But two players don't make up a team. Other Philly studs to watch for today. Scott Gabrielson, Wings captain and winner of the team's seventh man award. Scott leads the league in faceoffs. Second team, All-Pro Kevin Finneran. Kevin can certainly put the rack in the net, but his team-leading 19 assists proves he's the consummate team player. Johnny Nostrand, six-year veteran, two-time All-Pro. He's currently fifth on the team in goals with 10. Along with John's desire to win, his experience provides the Wings with leadership. Team MVP and first-team All-Pro goalie Dallas Elliott. Dallas feels they have the edge this year because the Bandits, quote, aren't the team they were last year. 1994 Major Indoor Lacrosse League Rookie of the Year, Tommy Hollywood Marichak, is certainly no rookie to the game. He played college lacrosse with Paul and Gary Gate at Syracuse University. Tom ended the regular season fourth in points for the league.
Bob the Hammer Hamley, he's the career leader in games played for Buffalo and is coming off a hat-trick game against the Detroit Turbos in the playoffs. This is a great threat. Anytime, anywhere, he can score. Why do they call him the Hammer? You figure it out. Jim Veltman, he's known as the human vacuum cleaner. Nobody rakes in as many ground balls as the Hoover. His 130 ground balls nearly double the next closest player in the league. Veltman was third in points and number one in assists. Troy Cordingley. To say that Troy stepped up his game would be an understatement. The retirement of two All-Pros, Keenan and Alexander, forced the Bandits to look elsewhere for offense. His fifth in the league in goals, good enough? Darris Kilgour, perhaps the toughest player in the league. He is the all-time leader in penalty minutes for the Bandits. Trash talking. Yeah, he can do that too. But Darris prefers to let his hustle do the talking. Tyson Lyons, he's a rookie, an impact player already in his first season. Tyson is one of the most athletic and acrobatic players in the league. Get in his way and prepare to be pummeled. Tyson seems to thrive on punishing his foes. And those are some of the key players to watch tonight. All right, this crowd is rocking. I'm telling you, it's wild here in Buffalo. We're all set for our final ESPN2 production of major indoor lacrosse. But today, we're on the mothership, ESPN. This is my position, right here in the penalty box. I'll be close to the action all night long. Throughout the season, if you've watched our games, you know that Christy Lee's been on the benches giving you inside stuff. Let's go to Christy Lee right now.
Leaf, you can tell I am not on the bench currently. We're actually in the Philadelphia Wings locker room pregame. And joining me is a guy that was actually on the field last year when that heart-stopping goal was scored by the Bandits to take away the championship. Tony Resch, now things are different. Not only are you not playing, you're actually coaching this team. I'm sure you're looking for a different outcome.
Oh, definitely. We had a tough loss up here last year. Obviously, one goal. We felt there were any number of things that could have gone differently, but unfortunately for us, they did not. So this year, you know, we're expecting another tight game. So every time out, we've talked to the players, and we need to win every single shift. We can't have a letdown mentally or physically at any time during the game, because between two good teams, you never know what's going to make the difference. So we're ready to play four full quarters or however long it takes, and hopefully we're going to be on top.
You've had a whole long year to think about it. Has it been eating you inside, that loss?
We were in this exact locker room last year, and we sort of made a commitment in the locker room right after the game that we'll be back, and the outcome's going to be different. And here we are, and we have our chance, and that's all you can ask.
All right. Tony Resch, good luck with those Wings tonight. Now we have their perspective. Let's check out the Bandits locker room.
If we go out tonight and we play every game with every shift in this game with intensity, we take care of our own defensive end first, and play within our game plan and our goals that we have set for ourselves, we will be successful, guys. You guys are the best team in this league. There is no better team in the league than this team. We stay committed, we work hard. Let's go out and show the rest of these people out here we're the best. Let's go, let's bring it in. Come on, let's go, Black, come on, let's bring it in, come on. Set, ready, 1, 2, 3, Bandits!
Today's major indoor lacrosse league world championship game on ESPN is brought to you by Coors Light. Coors Light in the MILL, check them out. My Adidas, the official footwear of the MILL. Adidas, the brand with three stripes. By Brine Lacrosse Equipment, official equipment supplier to the MILL and Buffalo Bandits. And by STX Lacrosse Equipment, official equipment supplier to the MILL and Philadelphia Wings.
Get it moving. The Silver Bullet has the taste to keep it moving. Coors Light. Naturally brewed for a taste that goes down easy. Coors Light. Keep on moving.
They're always working on something new.
That's why everyone who's serious about lacrosse plays with Sticks equipment.
My mother uses a stick.
With Sticks, you'll score more goals.
Probably 1,000, 100,000, 1,000,000.
The people at Sticks know the sport.
They're lacrosse players. Lacrosse players? I think my brother Paul works at Sticks. Every goal we scored was Sticks.
Sure do.
Can't say any more about it.
Back when baseball truly was the national pastime, ball players were heroes and great teams legendary. Now, Sports Illustrated brings you remarkable home movie footage of baseball's glory days in the award-winning two-video set, When It Was a Game. And best of all, both videos are free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated. When It Was a Game features never-before-seen home movie footage shot by the players themselves, bringing the ghosts of baseball's past to life. There's Gehrig and the Babe, Williams and DiMaggio, Ebbets Field, Fenway Park, and it's all in spectacular color. Call now and get both of these award-winning videos, along with 54 issues of Sports Illustrated, including the swimsuit issue for only $1.47 an issue. Save over 50% off the cover price. For quicker delivery, use your credit card. There's nothing like the magic of When It Was a Game, and there's nothing in the world like Sports Illustrated. Get into it.
By
Buffalo is a city that knows frustration. After the jubilation of going to four straight Super Bowls, the failure of bringing home the trophy sticks with the city. But this trophy, the North American Cup, is the proud ownership of the Bandits and the city of Buffalo. They are the best in the major indoor lacrosse league because of great talent like number 11, John Tavares, and number 43, Darris Kilgour. They've got the talent and they know the tricks. One of the tricks is the fast break. They are great at it. Watch how this works out with the offensive player being the yellow, the defensive player being the red. The offensive player in transition goes into the out-of-bounds door on one end of the substitution box, and the other player comes into the field on the other end. He picks up 15 feet. Look at the disadvantage that the red defensive player has. Now he is well behind the play. Buffalo works that like nobody else in the league. Now for more, let's go over to Christy Lee.
Well, Leap, let's talk a little bit about that fast break and how important it'll be for the Wings when they go against the Bandits tonight. Mike French is joining me, the general manager for the Philadelphia Wings. Mike, your fast break situation, is it a real important key factor?
Yeah, we feel that the more transition we play, the better off we are because we're a very athletic team, and so is Buffalo, but in many of the games where we've really taken big leads, it's because we've scored goals in bunches.
What about the power play?
Well, the power play is important for both teams. You got the best offensive players in the game of lacrosse playing on Buffalo and Philadelphia, so whoever takes the most penalties is going to be definitely hurting their team, and we hope that they make that mistake.
And you really want to take that home, that cup, that North American Cup, home to Philly.
Well, I think that's where it belongs. We've been in the championship five out of the last 6 years. We've won twice, and I think it's about time for us our turn again, so we're looking forward to taking it back.
All right, it's the Wings against the Bandits. We've taught you everything you need to know. When you come back, the rock will roll, and the game will start.
Seen the courage of heavyweight champion Evander Holyfield.
Holyfield gunning for a stoppage here.
Now meet his next challenger, Michael Moore.
They say I'm wild.
And Moore scored twice with the uppercut, and Stewart is down again.
They say I'm mean and arrogant.
Oh, down he goes.
I say they're right. Boxing's a tough business.
Every day, Cable Shopper brings you up-to-date information on the finest in area homes, all from the comfort of your home. You'll find a detailed description of properties for sale, along with full-color photos and local listing agents for you to call. If you're buying or selling a home, Cable Shopper is your most dynamic source of information. Watch Cable Shopper every day on Garden State Cable TV Channel 2.
No matter how tough, no matter how strong, is afraid to fall. The joking around, the chest pounding, all stop dead the moment you first touch the rock. Get to the top, and then you could pound your chest.
Two faces to watch, the best scorers in the league. Paul Gate, high-powered from the Philadelphia Wings. John Tavares, the total package from Buffalo. These are the one and two scorers in the major indoor lacrosse league. Watch them tonight. The goalie's always important. Dallas Elliott, the number one goalie in the league, voted by the players as first-team All-Pro in the mill. Bill Geary didn't start for his team till late in the season. Bill Geary, at 36 years old, has a huge pressure on him. He'll be tested early, and he has to come up big. Ross Cowie in the Wings, and he doesn't do well. The matchups, the Wings against the Bandits, you know that by now. Here's the crowd. They are standing room only inside the odd here in Buffalo. Leif Elsbo, Christy Lee. Now we're getting ready to go. Silcott in the orange for Buffalo. Gabrielson, number 8 for Philadelphia, wins the first faceoff. We are underway. Face-offs, of course, critical. You get possessions. Robbie Scheck now. They thought they had a separated shoulder last week. Robbie Scheck, number 18, on the field tonight. Left-handed shot. Geary deflects. Buffalo gets the ball. Both of these teams love the transition. Mike French talked about it, but Buffalo loves transition, too. As a matter of fact, in uneven situations, they are the most deadly team in the league. Here comes Stewart. Takes a shot wide of the goal. Interestingly enough, the two games this year, the leading scorers are not the Gates. The leading scorers, two matchups, Buffalo, Philadelphia this year. Stu Aird with 9 points, Veltman with 10 points for Buffalo. Follow-up shot in close by Volker. And Gary comes back to get the ball. I was talking about the leading scorers for the Bandits in head-to-head matchups. The leading scorers are Dedekin and Flynn. Black and silver for the Wings, orange and black for the Bandits from Buffalo. And you will hear the referee, Rich Tamburino, inside Derek Laub. Big save by Elliott. Buffalo does that so well. They get shots in that three alley, they call it Buffalo, the cylinder in the basketball lane, if you're a basketball fan, but just extend the pipes of the goal straight out, and that, of course, is your most efficient shooting area. Rogers, rookie from Villanova, to Maricek. Watch out for this guy. He gets double-teamed. They want to put pressure on him. Martin cannot collect it. Early double-team on Tommy Maricek. Troy accordingly tries to pick it up for the fast break. He's pushed. No, the ball goes out of bounds. It'll go to Philadelphia. We're inside of 2 minutes into the first quarter. The game has just started. This is for the North American Cup, the championship of major indoor lacrosse. Govett, a Canadian in the face of Gary, and he gets roped. Everybody else was getting attention on that line. Govett had some space. He came in, no double team, and he gets the first goal. Watch him get inside the defense. No slide to the cylinder. Nobody doubles him. Two fakes. Finally, far side beats Geary. Now, when he makes the pick move here to get open, Govett has a clear sail to the goal. No double team. And there's an easy goal. 1-0. Great move by Govett. Philadelphia takes the early lead. If you look at the last three times these teams have played, the team that led after the first quarter won the game. So scoring here is critical if you take that stat seriously. This is Paul Gate, the leading goal scorer in the league. Comes in with a left-handed shot and a big save by Geary. The follow-up. Hall still has it. Being ragged by Hall. Ball goes back to Geary. Outlet pass. Here we talked about out of the box. Out of the box was Rich Kilgour. He'll shoot and just misses the goal. That was exactly like our pregame.
Push.
Kilgour came flying out of the box, got the fast break, had a shot, but it was wide of the net. Tony Resch at the sideline. Buffalo looking to the inside. Veltman causes confusion. Comes in front, gets the ball, and wraps it around his shoulder. What a cut by Veltman. He had stepped on the crease, no call, and he hits the corner perfectly. Buffalo really crashes down that three alley. We had just talked about it. Off the ball, they are very active. Veltman came in, beat his man off the ball, got the feet, and wraps around behind his back. 1-1 the score. Johnny Nostrin takes the shot, and Geary makes the save. 11:30 left in the first quarter. Buffalo again. This team has a tremendous team concept, coached by Les Bartley, general manager John Maradian. They know this box game so well. Hartle, number 21.
Get up easy!
Again, you're hearing the mic'd referee, Stewie Aird, in close, number 36. Stewie Aird takes a shot, glove save, and a pipe brings the ball.
Pushing!
Push call gives the ball to Philadelphia. There's a 30-second shot clock. You've got to hit the face of the goal. You've got to hit the face of the goal to reset the shot clock. Here comes Philadelphia. They get it down. This is Dedekin.
Easy on the crease.
Finneran, the best feeder in the league. Up top. Watch Dedekin. Rope. Easy goal. Philadelphia cutting in front of the goal with Finneran, one of the best feeders in the league, certainly the best feeder on his team.
How long is it going to be?
He takes him behind. Finneran goes behind, gets the goalie to look back there, gets his attention. Dedekin wide open up top. Good cut by Dedekin, and he finishes it off. The redirection right there beats Troy accordingly. Or at least accordingly was the one sliding in there, but Dedekin had beaten his man to the open area. Finneran, the best assist man, found his mark. 2-1, Philadelphia, never behind in this game. They scored first, Buffalo answered. Philadelphia scores the third goal of the game. Again, Kevin Finneran, Ohio Wesleyan's best player possibly in history. Tell that the referees are trying to get some kind of attention. That one's in the crease.
It was in the net. It would have been a goal, but it was waved off because he was in the crease. That circle around the goal protects the goalie. If you step in it, you don't get the goal. Watch Gary. Gary comes in. That was an actual goal. It should have counted. He didn't step in the crease. Beautiful play. On the other end. Broke for Buffalo.
No goal. Crease violation.
Well, they waved off that one. Another crease violation down there. So the last two goals waved off because of crease violations. The score remains 2-1 in favor of the great
Black. Easy, easy.
Paul Gate off the pipe. Follow-up shot deflected by Geary.
Right here. Pushing this way.
All right, Rich Tamburino takes charge. Take a look at the Buffalo. No goal down here. In the crease was called again. Again, they get it in tight accordingly. He steps in the crease. There comes back out, shoots, and scores. They took it away from him because he stepped in the crease initially. Paul Gate takes a shot through a lot of traffic. Screens are very effective, as they would be in hockey.
Bring it up. He's getting a goal. He's getting a goal.
Philadelphia's Govett going against Bill Geary.
Interference.
There's Geary number 39.
Interference.
Custom-made helmet.
Orange ball.
Rich Tamburino is the referee right there. You're hearing him. He is mic'd. He goes through a lot of the wars on the field. He'll be in tight control of this game, and you'll be hearing it all. Down in the face of the goalie again is Rich Kilgour. Could not get the shot off because of the good defense of Philadelphia. 9 minutes left in the first.
Right there. 2 minutes. Get out of here.
Veltman gets called for a two-minute penalty on Hart. And Jim Veltman sets up the first power play for Philadelphia. Right around the neck. There it is with the off-stick hand. Just pulls him
he
down.
He grabs him. Holds. 2 minutes. 5-on-4.
5-on-4 in favor of Philadelphia. You know what? In each of the last three meetings against these teams, Buffalo has the first personal foul every time. This is the fourth straight time. It gives Philadelphia the advantage. In my estimation, if Philadelphia capitalizes on their power plays in this game, that means scoring 30 to 40%, they'll win the game. That's how important I think these are. Now the ball back to Denikin. Denikin takes a shot around Shaughnessy, but it hits Geary in the shoulder. Maricek gets called for a penalty. Tommy Maricek, 42. The referees will protect the face. Anything above the shoulders will be a highly critical area for goals.
42 cross checks him right in the face. 2 minutes.
Or for penalties, I should say. Now, the check is in here, and it's high to the face. And that's what the referees will not stand for. Now we've got a situation where it's 4-on-4. A lot of space. Tavares brings it down, number 11. Inside it, Kilgour makes a fake. He's got rope. Well, they own the free alley. Watch the feed into Kilgour, right in the free alley, right in the cylinder. He beats Elliott. It's all tied at 2.
My SportsCenter highlight goes like this. He hits a monster slap shot, but I catch it behind my back, frisbee style. And everyone's so stunned, I start skating. My coach is yelling, go. Bob leaves giving me directions, but I'm the amazing skating goalie, and I score the winning goal. Wow. Which gets me a dance with Ty Babylonia. Yeah, that's my SportsCenter highlight.
Tavares brings the ball in for offense. Look at the ragging defense by Chris Flynn, number 9. He's doubled against the boards by Robbie Scheck, number 18, All-American at Towson State. Christy Lee, my partner, is on the bench.
Easy
Christy.
Now. Ball's back.
That's right, Leaf. I am on the bench, and I'll tell you what, it is very, very stressful here. You heard Tony Resch say at the beginning of this game, he wanted his team to come out and score a lot of goals early because he doesn't want this crowd to get in the game. As you can see, the Bandits aren't letting that happen. We're all tied at 2, And we are going to keep you informed, although the guys have been real cooperative throughout the year. I don't know how much they're going to talk today, but we'll find out as much as we can down here.
All right, Christy, big opportunity for Philadelphia that went the way of Buffalo. It was a fast break. Check to Gary Gate, 22, and they didn't finish it. And that is critical. Gary Gate will finish 9 out of 10 of those, but Geary made the big save. Gary Gate could not pick it up easily. This is the fast break moments ago. Right now, though. Technical violation gives the ball back. Here's Nikula for Buffalo being ridden out by Scott Gabrielson. Nikula, very strong, likes to work that left-handed side. Checked out in the last moment. Ball down, and Nikula is leveled by Martin. Paul is leveled by Maracek, but here comes Brian Silcott. They've got to shoot quickly. Veltman gets a fresh shot clock with that overhand shot. Here comes Finneran. Look at the wheels on him. Great speed. The trailer is Denikin. Here comes Denikin with the shot. A little shovel shot pushed aside by Geary. He has looked strong, and Elliott has. Here comes Brian Nikula. He goes to the far side, but he's tired. Nikula looking for a little bit of a rest. Here's see number 12 go off, and Veltman has the ball. The hustle index, 9-7. Philadelphia leads that for the moment. Stewart inside, double teamed, and he is leveled. It'll be a hold call against Philadelphia. Buffalo ball. Under 6 minutes left in the first quarter. Tavares! This is the greatest player in the league. He steps up a notch in championship play. Watch him just walk around his defender, Maracek, and take the left-handed shot against Elliott. He bounces to the far side, finds the pipe. Johnny Tavares, the leading point scorer in the league. Fourth goal of the postseason. Tavares and the Gates have not dominated, but in this championship game, 3 goals for Buffalo, 2 assists by Tavares, 1 goal. He has come to play. Shaughnessy, 44, gives it over to Brian Silcott. 3-2 Buffalo with their very first lead of the game, and Tavares has had a hand in each and every goal. Darris Kilgour didn't play in the loss to Philadelphia. He tried to give it go to Cordingley, but Cordingley wasn't watching. Derek Lau, Bogate's all-time leading scorer, this time a shot in close, and a follow-up try by Cordingley before it is collected by Brian Volker. Brian Volker off to the trailing player, Bates. Now a fresh line comes off of Billy Miller. A great player from Hobart. Malmstrom's out there. Miller comes in against 2 players, Shaughnessy and Lobb. Working from behind the goal. Now he's still open in front, and Geary makes the save. Great one-on-one play by Billy Miller. Still alive. Volker takes a shot and is brushed aside again by Geary. Veltman, the vacuum cleaner, picks it up. Here is out of the box. That's that play we talked about. Lias just came flying out of the box. He's in front. Big save by Dallas Elliott. 2 times they've had opportunities on the fast break because of that fast break situation that we outlined in our open. And 2 times Dallas Elliott has turned it away. 4:20 left in the first quarter. 1 goal lead by Buffalo. Overhand shot by Sheck. Wide of the goal, and now it'll be Geary looking for the outlet. Well, Buffalo has turned back some of the emotion in the early game. Here's Tavares looking to get it inside to Rich Kilgour. A little flip to Stu Ayer, number 36. No, he fakes the flip. Had me faked out. He faked the flip to Stu Ayer and kept the ball. Moving pick violation gives it to Kevin Finneran. Finneran likes his left, takes the overhand shot. Great speed by Finneran. Now, Geary Gate. They're working from behind. Geary has to turn all the way around 180 degrees now, and the ball comes
easy,
out for the shot.
Easy! Easy, man!
Finneran takes a shot as Rich Tamburino, the referee, tries to control it. Watch out! Kilgour cannot pick up the fast break. Scott Gabrielson was run over. He'll go off for a fresh player. Ball will go back to Philadelphia. Watch Gabrielson get run over by Hartle. That gives it back to Philly. The fresh shot clock here is Paul Gate up front. Watch it. Rogers from Villanova goes for the corner. Wide again. Philadelphia's been wide on a lot of shots early on. This one goes to Tavares. McGarry a little too far in front. Tavares was defensed by Gary Martin. 3:10 left, first quarter. Buffalo leads by one. Philadelphia scored first. Buffalo answered. Philadelphia scored to make it 2-1, and then two goals by Buffalo. This is Paul Gates, leading scorer in the league. Giving it off to Chris Flynn. Hard shot. Go! Chris Flynn shoots 80% of his shots from that exact spot. The All-American from Penn ties it at 3. Chris Flynn, again, he goes for the right-handed shot out front. This is where he loves to shoot from. Just cranks it up, nothing but velocity. It's all tied at 3.
The thunder of hoofbeats. The swirling clouds of dust. A whole bunch of double-tough hombres. Looking for trouble and ready for action. The brand, WCW. The showdown, Spring Stampede. Sunday, April 17th, 7 p.m. Eastern. Live and only on pay-per-view.
Pioneer Mortgage knows there's no place like your new home. It's your hopes, your dreams, and your future all wrapped up in one. And we know there's nothing better than the feeling you get when your mortgage application is approved. Pioneer works with realtors and homebuyers every day, approving conventional, FHA, VA, 203K, adjustable, home equity, reverse mortgages, and more. So call 1-800-222-0057 now.
We know there's no place like your new home. And since 1980, there's no place like Pioneer for your new home mortgage.
We're all tied up, 3-3. And Steve Govett got hit pretty hard. Steve, are you all right?
Oh, yeah, I'll be fine.
A little check to the leg there.
Yeah, it's a war out there.
We also have an update on Scott Gabrielson for you. Scott's fine. He'll be back out there in just a few, Leaf.
All right. Chris Flynn, though, number 9, taking the faceoff for the gray and black team. That's Philadelphia. Darris Kilgour, number 43, picks it up cleanly for Buffalo. Bounce pass in close to Courtney Lee. Beautiful feed. The only way he could get that to Courtney Lee was to bounce it past the defender. He did that. Courtney Lee could not pick it up cleanly. This is Bates against Hamley. Open rope! Bates beats Hamley, gets right into the cylinder, and goes far pipe on Geary. Hammer Hamley got caught up on his feet, just failed him here. Watch how Hamley overcommits that side, gets caught up on his feet. Bates rolls beautifully to the inside. Watch that roll. Beats Hamley, no help on the slide. And Bates lays himself out, gets air, and gets a goal. Now, 4-3, the Wings lead after scoring 2 straight goals. They're back in front. 2 minutes left, first quarter. Leif Elsmo, Christy Lee on ESPN. We're on the mothership, but this is our Deuce presentation. We've had a full season of great action, a major indoor lacrosse. Every Monday night on the Deuce, starting in January. Paul Gate, watch out against Silcott. He's got room! Big save by Geary. The ball's still loose. Geary picks it up. Paul Gate, using that technique of coming out, exploding out of the substitution box, got the fast break. Silcott matched up beautifully with him. This is Johnny Tavares. His team is down by 1. It's 4-3 with 1:20 left. Veltman looks for cutters off the ball. There's Tavares. He loses it for a moment. In tight air, gets it brushed away. Picked up again. Hartle. Veltman cannot collect. Tavares. Defense by Maricek. Good pick and roll move. Tavares in close. Can't make it. Hold call against Philadelphia. Buffalo inbounds looking for a quick strike. Dallas Elliott picks it off. That's 2 minutes to a minute. Philadelphia leads by 1, and they have the ball. Can they extend this lead? Rogers. Rookie comes in, takes a shot right into Geary. Follow-up. Nobody picks it up. Finally, Paul Gate. This is a dangerous player with the ball. Down low into Jimmy Rogers. Check from behind by Tavares. Great check from behind on Tavares. Timeout called by Buffalo with 35 seconds
left. Timeout. Called by Buffalo. By FBI.
It's Les Bartley.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can.
Buffalo, so Les Bartley wants to get a goal with 35 seconds left.
Then we can wait for some people to come and help.
So Tony Rush gets his defense set up. But watch out for the offensive play by Bartley. I told you the stat of the last three games that the team who has led in the first quarter wins the game. That's the stats from the last three times they've matched up. Here's Paul Gate coming in. Beats Silcott, comes in, and Geary makes the big save. Whoa! And then how about the contact in this game? Here's Brian Nicula going for a loose ball, takes his eye off it for a moment, and he is leveled by Gary Martin.
Here we go.
Beavis and Butthead here, and they love the rock and roll style of Major Indoor Lacrosse. Play call by Les Bartley. A lot of action off the ball. Veltman starts with it. He's got 14 on the shot clock. Gets it into Rich Kilgour. Now off the ball, here comes Tavares looking for it, calling for it in the cylinder. This is Kilgour. Gets wrapped up. And Stu Air can't get it cleanly. Down to 10 seconds. Shot clock down to 5. They're going to lose possession here unless they shoot. Now. Shot clock violation. You're seeing the time left in the quarter. So Philadelphia will have 5 seconds to get it down the field. Probably not enough to even get a shot off. Flynn will pick it up. He just rockets one down toward Geary, hoping something weird will happen. Paul Gate gets it, almost does, and almost fills the net. Doesn't happen though. Good opportunistic play by Flynn. The first quarter ends with the Wings leading 4-3 in Buffalo.
Get it moving.
Keep on moving.
And the Silver Bullet has the taste to keep it moving. Coors Light. Naturally brewed for a taste that goes down easy. Coors Light. Keep on moving.
If you demand more from an aftershave than that same old alcohol burn, you need more than the same old aftershave. Sensitive from Old Spice. It's alcohol-free because alcohol burns. That's why they took it out and put these cooling scents they'd sent. For real refreshment to go with that great scent. It's proof aftershave doesn't have to hurt to work. So use Sensitive, or you might get burned. Take the heat out of aftershave. Demand proof. Try alcohol-free Sensitive from Old Spice.
Buffalo Bandits looking to three-peat. The arena is full of crazy fans for this indoor sport, and that's right, folks, the king is here. That's Elvis you hear in the background. Look at this record, 92. Buffalo wins the championship in overtime. Last year they went 13-12. This is their third year in the league, and Philadelphia wants to put an end to it right here. They've got a pretty good start. They lead 4-3 after one quarter play. And as I mentioned, if you believe in numbers, the last three times these two teams have met, the team that won the first quarter won the game. Goalies stay the same. Elliott now switches with Geary. They have swapped ends. They'll be going in opposite directions. Buffalo Veltman gets the first faceoff, but Finneran with a great check from behind.
Illegal
touch is the call. You heard that. So the ball will go back to Buffalo. Finneran looks around for his help. Stu Aaron gives it off to Hartle. Stu Aaron has 9 points against this team the two games this year. What a great year for Stu Aaron. Second team All-Pro at 36 years old, 37 right now. As a matter of fact, just had his birthday last month. Jimmy Veltman comes in, tries to give it to Tavares. Ball's loose. Violation, fresh shot clock. Christie on the sidelines. What do you have for us?
Well, Leaf, we have switched benches. We are now with the defending world champion, Buffalo Bandits. Les Bartley, the head coach of this team, just told his team, look, we got to step this up on defense if we want to keep that North American Cup here in Buffalo. Also, he said they're double teaming Johnny Tavares. So you guys are going to help him out, especially in the corners. So watch for a little bit more help for Tavares and stepped up defense from these Bandits.
All right, Christy, and something for you folks at home to watch. Tavares right there, number 11. So he's getting a lot of attention. Double teams. Obviously, just like any other sport, you double team him. Somebody's
silver
open.
Holds Philadelphia 3. 2 minutes.
All right, Paul Denikin, number 3, called for a hold. It'll be power play for Buffalo. Philadelphia just dominating in shots. That's unusual for Buffalo. And then loose balls barely controlled by Buffalo and faceoff again in Philadelphia's favor. Shots, really the telling number there. They ended up with the lead in the first quarter. And of course, having that many shots, Bill Geary had a great first quarter just to keep his team in it. This is a power play, 5-4. Hamley takes it from out front, deflected out of bounds by Elliott. They'll stay right here. This team desperately needs to find the net. They don't want a big margin to open up in favor of Philadelphia. That was Tavares on the back door trying to get that thing open. This is Kilgour. Hamley. Power play looking for rope. Back door and Kilgour brushed away by Veltman. Not a good shot so far. Great defensive play by Philadelphia. This is Billy Miller. Accordingly, tries to run with him. Accordingly, not playing 100%. You can tell when he tries to run hard. He cannot cut off his right foot. Check. Now, this is a man down. They are still man down for a minute 16, so Buffalo won't do anything fancy here. They'll try to just give him the 30 seconds with the ball and get it back. 4 seconds left on the shot clock for Philly. Hall picks it up, and now with a minute left, they'll reload the power play for Buffalo. Kilgour had gone off. He's back on right now. Darris Kilgour did not play in Philadelphia when Philadelphia beat Buffalo for the only time in their history. Kilgour is right there. He had the game winner last year against this team. There's rope from Veltman. Gets it started. He works it 1-2 right there with Veltman. Veltman just takes a step in. He didn't get challenged that much by Martin. And just takes it. Look at it. He takes a little stutter step. Martin didn't challenge him very much. He saw a target and he nails it. Second goal today for Veltman. The score tied again 4-4. It was tied at 1. It was tied at 2. Tied at 3, and here we go.
You got it.
Ball game misses wide to the left. Ryan Nicola trying to pick it up against Scott Gabrielson. And he is double teamed by Maricek Silcott off to the races. The great player from Nazareth gives it off to Ryan Nicola, who's defensed by Martin, 33. Nicola's got a great left hand. He likes it right there. And a good save by Elliott. First team all pro. Silcott has to stop it before it goes behind that midline. That will be back court. Third title since they joined this Major Indoor Lacrosse League in 1992. They lost their first 3 games when they came into the league. Then they won 22 straight and 2 world titles before they were beaten twice this year. They are predominantly Canadian players who know the box game very well. Philadelphia, a little bit more American in their roster. Govett comes in, big shot against Geary, a save. In the crease, violation will go back to Buffalo. Game tied at 4, 11:49 left in the second period. Leif Elsbow and Christy Lee with our deuce coverage on ESPN. Watch this, Govett will launch himself in, he gets air. Big save by Geary. Geary just fills it up once he got air. He couldn't go down low effectively, so Geary went up as Govett went up. Veltman tries to pick up the ball, the feed into him. Again, good cutting for Buffalo off of the ball. Stuart tries to nail Paul Gate. He missed him, and now we may have trouble because of the fast-breaking ability of Paul Gate. But the defensive Kilgour was back there waiting. Volker. Billy Miller will go down and start things in the corner. We saw Miller take it behind before. Miller now working out front, checked out to Bates.
Next goal. You got it, big guy.
Tavares. Looks for help in the air, gets it to Ann Stewart!
1 minute commercial.
The Bandits lead by one.
Hi.
Hey.
So how'd it go today?
I've been called back for a second interview.
That's great.
Looking for a job keeps me busier than when I have one.
Speaking of busy, I better get dinner started. What do you say we go out to dinner? My treat.
Only McDonald's gives you extra time and extra value meals starting at $2.99.
Dad, when you get your new job, let's go back to the old way, where you pay.
What you want is what
Why?
You get at McDonald's tonight.
You just spray it on?
You just spray it on.
New Quicksilver wheel cleaner from Armor All. Just spray it on, and then just spray it off.
That's it? That's it.
Quicksilver wheel cleaner.
Leave it to Peerless Faucet to create a shower so smart, it can not only sense when a toilet has been flushed, it can also adjust the water temperature accordingly. Scald Guard technology by Peerless. Get more out of your faucet than just water.
Working on the Philadelphia bench, they are now behind by one. It's a game that has seesawed as any championship should with two great teams trying to close that wound.
All right, man, here we go.
Philadelphia brought a couple truckloads, a couple busloads of fans themselves up here. The Spectrum really follows the team on the wings. Accordingly, in a fast break, he's got throat. A two-goal lead. Cornelly was parked. Look how far he is. He's just parked down there. No defender saw him. He takes a foul shot and beats Elliott. Great shot by Troy Cornelly, his second year in the league. 6-4 now, a two-goal margin for Buffalo. The first two-goal margin for Buffalo in the game. Philadelphia started off by scoring first in this one. So Buffalo's been playing a little bit of catch-up. They did have a lead earlier this one, but now 6-4. Veteran has the ball for Philly. That really stung Philadelphia because Cornelly was not playing at all. Here comes Hammer Hamley. Gary Gate falling behind. Hamley pulls back the right hand. He's got through. Defense of Gary Gate, and they are going wild. Watch Hamley. Look at Gary Gate. He pulls the stick back so Gate can't get it. One-handed shot beats Elliott. Beautifully done. Cornelly and Hamley. Cornelly now tries to take the other player out of it, but Hamley knows Gary Gate's the only guy that can get him. Gary Gate swats at a stick. He switches to right hand. One hands it past Elliott. Free goal lead for the hometown Bandits, and they are turning on the offense.
Get into quality. Get into savings. Get into Toyota. Get into Liberty Toyota's 10th anniversary celebration. Choose from a great selection of new and used cars and a great selection of new and used trucks at South Jersey's number one truck dealer. The deals have never been better. You can save thousands. Shop early for best selection. Get into quality. Get into savings. And get to the 10th anniversary celebration at the giant Liberty Toyota Auto Complex, Route 130 in Jerome Street, Burlington, New Jersey. Liberty Toyota, minutes from Pennsylvania at the foot of the Burlington-Bristol Bridge.
Pedal in for savings at Eastern Sports Specialists for family bike rides or hardcore training. Eastern Sports Specialists has a bike that's right for you. Mountain bikes, racing bikes, leisure bikes for adults and kids. Our technically trained staff, led by Stan Ricciuti, service and repair all makes and models. We sell helmets, clothes for men and women, and all the accessories you need for your cycling fun. So pedal in to Eastern Sports Specialists on Route 38 at Larchmont Boulevard, Mount Laurel.
We're back at the Rocking Odd in Buffalo. 7-4, the magic three-goal lead. John Tavares, we know how tough it is to come from behind, especially a team like you. What is it about Dallas Elliott? You guys seem to be getting it in on him.
Well, it just seems we're getting lucky right now. We're just shooting the ball and hoping it's going in. Dallas is a great goaltender in this league, and we're just shooting towards the goal. That's all we're doing.
How about these fans here in Buffalo?
They're great, but it's a long way from over. We got to keep in this game.
All right, thank you, John Tavares. Back up to you, Lee.
All right, Chrissy, you forgot. I'm not up. I'm over, baby. I'm right across the field from you in the penalty box. We are both down the field. Christy Lee in the benches. Lee Felsmo here in the penalty box position. Our deuce coverage on the mothership ESPN of Major Indoor Lacrosse, the championship game. Defending champion Buffalo in the orange and black with the 7-4 lead over Philadelphia. This has been the matchup for the last 3 years.
Make sure shot clock's still 11. Shot clock's at 11.
Tyson Elias is down. Just tired. Here's the hit. We got a penalty now coming up. Still down on the field. Way on the defensive end. That is
just
Tyson
remember
Elias.
Where you're at in the shot clock, right?
We are in the second quarter. 7-4 is the score. The defending champions from Buffalo. We're in Buffalo, and they are leading. This game was seesaw through the first quarter. This is the Major Indoor Lacrosse League Championship playing for the North American Cup.
Okay, it's 17. It's not 11. That looks like 11.
And right now we have an injury to Tyson Elias, the good-looking
rookie. He looked to me like he had checked the guy who was turning and fell off of him and hit himself.
You're hearing Rich Tamburino. We have Mike, the referee, and you'll hear him chat throughout the game. We'll take a short break as they
I had a guy
tend to Tyson Elias. We'll be back with more of our second quarter from the odd in Buffalo.
It's a major breakthrough in auto protectant technology. Formula 2001 Super Protectant. It provides a more brilliant, longer-lasting shine than Armorall on vinyl and leather. And look, in the Arizona desert, Formula 2001 brought back the shine to UV-faded vinyl, rubber, even leather. Get the new standard in automotive protectant technology. Formula 2001, with 50% more active shining ingredients than Armorall. Get Formula 2001 products today.
My hair is so dry, I thought no way a 2-in-1 could work. Then I tried Pert Plus Extra Conditioning. It really works. So even my hair gets soft.
Pert Plus Extra Conditioning. Great hair, no fuss.
Toss me the ball.
King Griffey Jr.'s always play hardball. That's why King Griffey Jr. presents Major League Baseball as wall-to-wall action. Only on the Super NES Sports Network. It's the one game that plays in Kinsley.
Let's see you hit.
Tomorrow night on ESPN, Sunday Night Baseball. The Orioles with that reloaded offense featuring Rafael Palmeiro and Clark for Texas. Those two, of course, involved in all that trade in the offseason. They want to go head-to-head and do so well. That is the feature game tomorrow on ESPN, 8 p.m. Eastern Time. Orioles and Rangers, Sunday Night Baseball. Right now, Tyson Elias with, unfortunately, a terrible injury to him. 3-goal lead for the defending champions. You have joined us in the second quarter. The Major Indoor Lacrosse League Championship. Let's watch as Elias gets his injury down here deep in the defensive end. He's playing defense, gets a big check that goes over, and right in there somewhere, he tore up his knee pretty good. He's having a tough time walking off. You can see how he went over the player, Billy Miller, and he never really got up from that hit. Glenn Lay carrying him off. Tyson Elias, one of the great-looking rookie crop coming into this Buffalo squad. They've won the last two North American Cups, but there are 11 players that have played them both. They keep retooling with young guys. Stu Aird's a great player, not one of the young guys. He's 37, but a second-team All-Pro.
We gotta wait for the gate to be closed. We can't play with the gate open, big guy.
Buffalo with four unanswered goals.
Here we go, man.
From behind, it was 4-3 in favor of Philadelphia before Buffalo really turned on the offense. They've done it with fast-break style. Now they try to get it over to Hartle, who can't pick it up. Veltman, the vacuum cleaner, he'll get it. Now he does. He gets the other man off him. Gaberson with his off hand, but now finally checked to the floor. Here comes Gary Martin. He's got Miller. He's got Flynn behind him. Miller on the far side. Flynn calls for it. Maricek takes it, though. Now over to Flynn. Flynn likes that to the goalie's right. That right-handed shot. That's where he loves to shoot. He already has one goal from there tonight. 9 minutes left, second quarter, 3-goal lead for Buffalo. Paul Gate. No Gate score so far, by the way, folks. Not an assist, not a goal from either of the Gates. Meanwhile, Tavares is a big part of it, so. Oh, there's one rope for Paul Gate. Wraps it around his back, acrobatic shot. Beautiful.
Right there, 36 holes, 2 minutes right there.
And what you're hearing Tamburino say is that there was a penalty before the shot. The goal wipes it out.
Penalty on orange 36.
Watch him work the ball behind. They've done this all day. making a lot of confusing cuts here against the defense. Gate takes it in the defense of three players. Looks like they were zoning up on him. And he wraps it around, beats Geary to the fifth goal of the game.
Even. Holding penalty wiped out.
Paul Gates. Just as I mentioned, they hadn't scored yet. He puts in a tremendous goal around the back. Make it 7-5 with 8:50 left in the second quarter. Anybody's game in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. If you're within three goals, it can change within a minute. Cordley tries to pick up the feed right down the alley, right down the cylinder. He tries to get it in the lane. Couldn't pick it up cleanly. Buffalo's been very effective with that. Camarino trying to take charge, not taking anything from anybody. That's what you're hearing in the background, the referee taking charge. Geary now brings the ball all the way up. They're not playing him. They're playing the other players. Here comes Hamley. Takes a shot. Of a defenseman that is so unorthodox and confused defense. Geary came up so far, second goal today by Hamley. He finally got attention on the defense, gave Hamley some room. 8-5, Buffalo leads. 8 minutes left in the second. Nicola off to Glenn Lane. Some far out, some up close, but he is not playing with confidence right now because he has been rocked for 9 goals and there are still 7.5 minutes left in the first period. Here's a guy in a team who averages 11 goals against on defense. So this is unheard of. They've almost scored a game's worth of goals against Dallas Elliott. The Bandits second this year with 15 goals per game, second in Philadelphia. Welcome. He's taken down. The hole will be the call. Go back to Philadelphia. Chris Flynn will inbound. Well, Philadelphia thought they had things going pretty well. Nostrad bounced off of Melton's helmet. It should stay for Philadelphia.
Silver ball.
It was 4-3 early on.
Man and went out of bounds.
And now it's been just a lot of offense for Buffalo to get a 4-goal lead. Christy Lee, what do you have on the sideline?
Well, as you can imagine, Les Bartley and his clan are pretty darn happy with that 4-goal lead. He told his players just a few moments ago, let's make things happen. And I can tell you that they are making things happen despite the fact that Chris Flynn just scored for the Wings. This team is fired up. They are motivated. And look for some surprises to come out of Les Bartley's little bag.
All right, Chris Flynn's a great player. But as I mentioned before, if you took away that spot on the artificial surface, he'd be very unhappy because he always shoots almost 80% of his shots from that one spot. He's got a great right-handed shot, and he has his second goal of the day. Accordingly, takes one against Elliott. It's deflected off his legs. The score now is 9-6 in favor of the defending champion Bandits. Here comes Geary Gate. He's so great in the open field. Fakes, goes the back door. Finner in. Can't beat Geary. Shaughnessy can't pick it up cleanly. Watch out. Here comes Gabrielson, the back door again to Finneran. Ball loosed to Shaughnessy. They'll call a hold against Buffalo and give it to Philadelphia. Everybody else was running downfield. Everybody on the field thought it was going the other way. All the players saw it differently than Tommy Young, the ref. Watch this. Here's Gabrielson shoving down the other player. They gave it back to Gabrielson. All the other players were running down the other way. Now Gate inbounds Finnery. Right left hand. Paul Geary Gate, rather, number 22. Identical twins, Paul and Geary Gate, numbers 19 and number 22. Big controversy, folks, this year with Paul and Geary. They've always played on the same line together. This year they separated them. They played on two different lines. They end up getting a lot of floor time together because they play on the power play. But that has been a bone of controversy because what is the defensive strategy against one or two? Philadelphia feels they're more effective having one gate out there longer than two gates playing together. Does that make any sense? Here comes Philadelphia. 9-6. They are behind by three. Gary Gate against Silcott. Back to Kevin Finner. Finner hardly ever looks at who he's going to feed to. Watch. He'll look one way, feed the other. That way on time, he looked right at Gary. Gave it to him. Brian Hall playing defense. Big size mismatch here. Brian Hall, he's very tough. Gary wrapped that one around, trying to get it to Finner in the back door. Veltman on the run against Paul Gate. It's Veltman and Paul Gate. Veltman makes a move. He wants a left-handed shot. Takes it. Good save by Elliott. Veltman will be tired. He'll go back and play defense, but he is really tired out there. Two or three runs down. Easy. Early, you get two runs, and you're off the field. So Veltman's looking for a little bit of rest. Gary gets nailed. He's okay. Here comes a fast break again. Kilgour out of the box comes Cordingley. Cordingley takes it from the box. Oh, couldn't pick it up cleanly. Tavares. He's nailed. Cardo picks up the loose ball against Kevin Finneran. Aird's up top, and he'll now control. Aird sees some space inside to Cordingley, who couldn't get it again. Twice, Cordingley could not pick up the loose ball. Once off of the box, off of the bench area. And that time, he couldn't get it cleanly from up top. Look at the gates. Paul, 1-1. Gary, no goals, no assists. They are critical. They've got a score, and Philadelphia's going to win. In close, looked like Rogers or Govett working inside, and they get a goal. Beautiful job for Philadelphia. They cut the lead to 2. It's 9-7. Philadelphia's bench confident.
Right, just tell me if you
watch how they work it in close. Barachek, great feeder, gets it in to Rogers, 14, and he redirects it past Geary. Beautiful job now. Rogers is right where he should be. Barachek gets the attention of the defense, and Cordingley slides in too late. So tough run for Cordingley. Cordingley missed two passes on the offensive end, and then that defensive lapse cost them a goal. 9-7 is the score, not 9-6. 3 goals separate. Under 4 minutes to go here in the second quarter. Hammer Hamley controls up top. He's being ridden off by Bates. Hamley tried to get it to Cordingley again. They're really forcing it into Cordingley, who's had a tough time getting a stick on it. This is Billy Miller against Darris Kilgour. Miller, good move across the cylinder. He's open, but Kilgour wraps the defensive check around his head. Open up top is Hamley. He cannot collect the ball. Check defending. Hamley a little too tired to get underneath of that one. But Buffalo looking for the fast break, the explosion from transition. Hard shot by Nostrand up top. Here's another hard shooter. Check. Billy Miller takes a left-handed shot wide of the goal. Shot clock down to 11. This will be... No, it's not a backdoor. Christy Lee, update on the injuries.
Yeah, earlier in this quarter, Leaf Tyson Lyons went down pretty hard. It apparently is his hip. Neither the coach or the trainer on the bench knows if Tyson's going to return to the game. We're probably not finding that out until about halftime.
All right, I'm sure everybody thinks about Bo Jackson, how a seemingly small injury can turn to a big one, so we'll keep you posted on Tyson Lias. The score now 9-7, 2:40 left, second quarter. Our deuce coverage of Major League World Cross. This is the championship game. All the marbles right here, the two best teams. Nicula. Shot clock violation, I believe. Whistles the ball dead. Timeout called by Philadelphia. 2:27 left and a 2-minute lead by Buffalo. And Philadelphia has called a timeout. Philadelphia has settled down a little bit. And Tyson Lyons is back on the field. We'll be back with the closing moments of the second quarter in just a moment.
You guys getting this? Huh? Is this great or what? Just me and the great one. Nice pass, Gretz.
I'm gonna be showing this to my grandkids. My grandkids' kids. Who am I kidding? I'm gonna be watching this on a loop in my own house. With my friends, charge a buck for every guy. You know what? He's not as big as I thought he was. I think I could take him.
Nice pass, Gretz. Yeah.
Wayne, that last pass a little bit outside.
I'll work on it.
Geary, that's the call for the Buffalo fans. He's the starting goalie. They've got two of them. This is Tyson Lias. We were worried about his hip. He was down for a long time with an injury. He is back on the field. Moments after Christy Lee gave us that update on his hip, he came running onto the field as we went to the break, and the crowd went nuts. They can use this big tough guy, Kevin Finneran, number 11 for Philadelphia, the leader in the league in assists, the leader on his team in assists. Now the ball will be inbounded by Gary Gate, number 22. No points yet for Gary. He's defensed by Veltman. Darris Kilgour now defending against Finneran. They work the ball behind as they have all most of this first half. They're getting a lot of cuts off the ball. Giving the ball back. Veltman wanted to get off the field, but he couldn't do it in time. He was tired. He couldn't believe the push call gave the ball back to Philadelphia. Paul Gate, he can shoot from there, and a big foot save by Gary. Veltman goes way up with that huge wingspan, pulls that one down, but it's dropped again. Christy Lee, Tyson, how's he feeling?
Well, Tyson, you scared some people out here when you went down. What was the problem?
Landon, I think it was on whoever it was, his back of his shoe, and the hard rubber heel hit the back of my hip bone and just sort of paralyzed my leg for a couple minutes. So they just took me off, did a little test, made sure everything was functioning fine.
All right, thank you very much. Tyson Lyons back in the game, Leaf.
Fast break. Darris Kilgour can't pick it up. Follow up by Rich Kilgour, and they can't get it cleanly. They had a great fast break going. They've had several of them. Here comes Tavares, looks for air. It's checked out by Paul Gate. Great defense by Paul. Watch out, Stu Aird with another shot. A follow-up by Aird, and a great save by Elliott. So Buffalo has had exceptional offense, but great defense by Philadelphia has kept them out of the net. No rope for some time now for Buffalo. About 6 minutes have gone by since Buffalo has scored. Meanwhile, Flynn and Rogers have scored for Philadelphia. This is the Hammer Hammett. He's got a couple already today. Shaughnessy trying to work the pick and roll on the far side. Cutting down is Cordingley. Cordingley redirects right into the face of Dallas Elliott. Volker can't get it clean. Here comes Tyson Lyons. Lyons looking strong. Runs over Volker. On a mission. Watch him. Number 49 for Buffalo came out of the medical tent with a clean bill of health. Now he gives Gary, or Paul Gate rather, to Shaughnessy. Tough assignment for Shaughnessy. All the way over. Watch out. Chris Flynn's in his favorite spot. Makes a little move inside and loses the possession. To Philadelphia with a two-goal deficit to make up under 1 minute. 40 seconds left in the half. Watch Barachek. He's got a great feeder. He can feed behind his back, right, left-handed. Hard shot in close. He had two or three defenders on him. Ground ball is so important. I think Philadelphia's done a great job of working the ground ball. Here's the category. Buffalo dominates. Timeout called by Buffalo with 22 seconds left. So Christie's on that bench. Hopefully she can stick her ear in there and hear what play they're going to call. They'll have the ball, Buffalo will. Right. They've got a two-goal lead.
Right, I got it.
And they want one more goal to go into the half.
Okay, let's push it up here. We're going to throw a goalie. We're going with 6-on-5 right here. I want to play to one shot. Pardon me?
6-on-5, guys.
6-on-5, 5 seconds. We work the clock. Not sooner. We just hold on the ball. Tyson is. He's the only one that knows it. We want to hold on to the ball.
A big guy, are you set?
All right, Bill Geary has gone to the bench. They're putting six players on there. They have no goalie. The goalie is out. So they're going to play for the last shot. You heard Les Bartley. 22 seconds left. They'll have six players because they have no goalie. Obviously, in this situation, it's critical not to give it up before this half winds down. Shot clock is not a factor. And the risk here is that if you give it up, you've got a shot on the other end with no net. Hamley will hustle back if that happens. They'll go look at the pressure put on for that very reason, because of the risk factor. Into Veltman looking for Rome. He's got it. Hat his target and nails it. And look, the first thing he does is check the clock to make sure there's not enough time left. He checks to see if he got it down tight enough. There were 5 seconds left. Great job by Jimmy Veltman. A hat trick in the first half. The crowd loves it. The Bandits lead by 3.
Get it moving. Keep on moving. Keep on moving. And the silver bullet has the taste to keep it moving. Coors Light. Naturally brewed for a taste that goes down easy. Coors Light. Keep on moving.
The power behind the game.
New Nutrageous from Reese's. Peanuts, milk chocolate, caramel, Reese's peanut butter. New Nutrageous. Give your mouth a party.
If you demand more from an aftershave than alcohol burn, you gotta try alcohol-free sensitive. With Cooling Sensates, it's proof aftershave doesn't have to hurt to work. Take the heat out of aftershave. Demand proof. Try alcohol-free sensitive from Old Spice.
Welcome to the Coors Light Halftime Report. Tonight's Major Indoor Lacrosse League Game of the Week is brought to you by the Buffalo Hilton at the Waterfront, official headquarters of the Major Indoor Lacrosse League in Buffalo. And that's exactly where we are, in Buffalo at the Odd, where the world champions, the Buffalo Bandits, are leading the Philadelphia Wings 10-7 in this crucial, the marble game, the championship game. You're watching two of the best teams in this league, but how about the best players in the league? We're going to take a look right now. Guys in the tape, let's roll. Now, here's your All-Pro first team from the Buffalo Bandits, John Tavares. He was second in the league in goals with 27, tied for second in assists with 20, and was number one in total points with 47. Tavares named player of the game 3 times and player of the week once. Player number two from the Philadelphia Wings, Paul Gate. Paul is number one in goals with 31, including a league record 10 in one game, and ranked second in points with 44. Paul was also 2-time player of the game and player of the week for his 10-goal effort. Also from the Philadelphia Wings, Gary Gate. His 16 goals and 17 assists were good enough for the 4th best in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. Together, he and twin brother Paul are the most explosive offensive fury ever. From the Bandits, Jim Veltman, known as the human vacuum cleaner. Veltman's 130 loose balls were almost twice as many as the nearest competitor. To further exemplify his unselfish attitude, he led the league in assists with 24 and was player of the week back on February 7th. From the Boston Blazers, Tim Sudan. Although missing a few games because of an injury, Sudan showed steady play and key leadership. And in goal, from the Philadelphia Wings, Dallas Elliott. Dallas was second in the league in saves per game, twice player of the game, and also player of the week on March 22nd. Dallas, known for his acrobatic saves, is also not afraid of distributing a hard check every now and then. Now, let's take a look at the second team. From the Detroit Turbos, wild man Ted Dowling. Ted was third in the league in goals with 21 and player of the month in February. From the Boston Blazers, Tom Carmine. Tom was 9th in assists and player of the week back on February 15th. From the Bandits, veteran Stu Aird. At age 36, Stu lets his actions on the field do the talking. From the Wings, Kevin Finneran. Kevin, 4th in assists and 7th overall in scoring. From the Baltimore Thunder, Lindsey Dixon. Dixon, in his second year, is the lone Thunder All-Pro. And representing the New York Saints, goalie Sal LoCascio. Sal was first in saves per game and second in save percentage.
Armorall tire foam. It cleans, it shines, it makes tires look like new. Now do you believe?
You work harder, you get better, right? But working to condition my perm made it flatter. Then I found this, Pert Plus, just right for perms. Now my perm's fuller than with separate shampoos and conditioners, and very soft.
Welcome back to the Coors Light Halftime Report. The Major Indoor Lacrosse League World Championship game. We're at halftime where the Bandits lead the Wings 10-7. The Major Indoor Lacrosse League is a unique organization. The team is owned by just a handful of people. How'd this all start? What's it all about? Let's take a look. Hey, got a few extra bucks? Want to buy a sports franchise? How about the Philadelphia Eagles, who sold for $185 million? Or the Florida Marlins, that sale cooled $150 million. Better yet, why not go for the Florida Panthers? Pocket change is just $150 million. Imagine, you could be the next George Steinbrenner or Jerry Jones. Well, meet Russ Klein and Chris Britt, founders of the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. They are living the ultimate dream. 10 years ago, they decided to start their own league by owning all the teams and were faced with many challenges.
The challenges, there were some obvious ones. The money, the getting teams together, players together, but probably the biggest challenge of all is just no roadmap. We were putting this thing together and no one had ever owned a league and all the teams. And now we see that becoming a new way of doing things in sports today. We see people who are starting the new leagues, the World League of American Football over in Europe and some other leagues are going to use this. We started this process, we developed the roadmap, and I think it'll be helpful for them.
Not only did they develop the roadmap, but they realized the most important aspect. In order to be a success, gotta please the fans.
Fans are everything. And if you've went to one of our games, not only are they seeing a great product that is affordable, but the fans make this game.
It's on the cross, number one! In your face! Hey, in your face!
The players are weekend warriors in the true sense of the word. The top guy only makes about $450 per game. A rookie, $150. Compare that to the average salary for the top four sports. Baseball, $1.2 million. Basketball, let's see, about $1.3 million. Football, $644,000 or so. And hockey, a cool half mil.
Yes, if you look at the success of the league and you put it in comparison to what Jerry Jones paid Jimmy Johnson more to leave than we gross in a year, that tells you where we're at.
For now, player relations with the league, good. In fact, most guys probably play for free. The league is looking to expand, hopefully, to two more teams in 95.
We have a great product. That's what people want today. And we believe in it, and we think that if we continue to do the things that are right for everyone concerned, this sport is going to compete and do well in the entertainment market. You know you've made it big when the President of the United States calls. Mr. President, I'll be waiting for you.
It still bugs me that I waited to try Old Spice High Endurance just because I thought all deodorants worked the same. Dumb. This proves it's the best. Better than the leading stick. It evaporates less quickly. It also lasts longer. Protects better. You can't ignore that. Or this guarantee. Try it. If you don't think it's the best, call 1-800-PROVE-IT, and they'll buy you a stick of yours. You gotta figure anyone that serious about deodorant deserves a serious shot. OK? Come on, take the high endurance challenge from Old Spice. I did.
Back when baseball truly was the national pastime, ball players were heroes and great teams legendary. Now, Sports Illustrated brings you remarkable home movie footage of baseball's glory days in the award-winning two-video set, When It Was a Game. And best of all, both videos are free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated. When It Was a Game features never-before-seen home movie footage shot by the players themselves, bringing the ghosts of baseball's past to life. There's Gehrig and the Babe, Williams and DiMaggio, Ebbets Field, Fenway Park, and it's all in spectacular color. Call now and get both of these award-winning videos, along with 54 issues of Sports Illustrated, including the swimsuit issue for only $1.47 an issue. Save over 50% off the cover price. For quicker delivery, use your credit card. There's nothing like the magic of When It Was a Game. And there's nothing in the world like Sports Illustrated. Get into it.
Welcome back to the On in Buffalo. Lee Elsmo and Christy Lee. The championship game for the major indoor lacrosse for the North American Cup. Right now, 10-7 lead by the Bandits, the home team, the Buffalo team, the team that is really facing an uphill battle to three-peat against a very physical and very talented Philadelphia squad. Let's look at the stats in the first half. The number that jumps out, the third one down, loose balls. Buffalo, 13 more loose balls than Philadelphia. Of course, that gets you in transition. And if you remember back at the first half, they had a lot of shots in transition in the face of Dallas Elliott. It got him unsettled, and it got them a six-goal second quarter. Let's take a look at the shot chart and take a look at the efficiency of shooting. The red area, the prime shooting area for the Bandits, that is where they've gotten seven goals. That same thing I just talked about, transition, fast breaks. They kick it right into the face of Dallas Elliott, and that has been successful for them. The Wings, only four goals, eight shots in the red area. They've got two from out on the left there to the goalie's right. That's Chris Flynn. Both of those are his goals. And one back there, back door. So they don't have as many shots in the red target area, right down the cylinder, right in the lane, the three alley, as Buffalo calls it. And that is critical to the effective use of your offense. When we come back, this man, Dallas Elliott, will try to be the defense that takes his team to the new championship.
Hi, I'm Tina. This is my baby. I feed her, nurture her, and I guide her. Believe me. At 130 miles an hour, when she starts to whine, I'm a real mother.
There's Bill Geary. He has had a great first half, the customized paint job in the helmet, but maybe the most impressive part of the first half was what he did offensively. He came up late in that first half and really confused the defense. Here he is up top. He gave it off to Hamley finally and then to Veltman, but the defense was confused because Geary came all the way up and effectively gave them a 6-on-5, and that gave Veltman the open shot. Les Bartley has had his troops in there for the halftime. Bartley took over this team after those three losses in the first season. He went off and won 22 straight as head coach of this team. He, along with John Moradia, have this team playing on the same page. Dallas Elliott, first team All-Pro. He is sensational, but that fast break offense got him rattled in the second quarter. I think you'll agree he was not as confident as he might have been because there were a lot of shots right in his face, and they scored six in the second quarter to get this 10-7 lead. Philadelphia, Chris Flynn, back to Bulger. They control the first faceoff. Line switching so they get
relax
back
and play
on the field.
Ball.
Referee's trying to get control. Gary Gate goes behind. Now he's going to come launching out. He had one that was very close to a goal, not called a goal. Comes around from the left.
That's a goal.
They're going to call it good. Good goal.
No argument. It went over the goal line. It went over the goal line. It's a goal.
Bill Geary got caught in the net.
No, he didn't. It's over. It's a goal. Get ready to play. It's a goal.
What happens is watch Geary get caught up in the back. His stick gets in the net. Right there, he's locked up. Now the net is offline, but the shot crossed the plane of the goal. You see the line on the green there in the crease. That would have been a goal in a normal situation with the goal set properly. The referees have to allow it to count. Good play by Gary Gate, who gets credit for it. And the first goal of the second quarter, the second half rather, scored by Philadelphia. They now are down by 2, 10-8, and they get the second faceoff. So Philadelphia has really coming out with a lot of energy here. Daniken bounces one off the pipe. Sheck takes a hard one off the back door. Here comes Finneran. In close, watch Daniken, he puts it home, he's got rope. Philadelphia coming out with a lot of intensity and have put it in the face of Buffalo. Buffalo, they look flat. And all of a sudden, it's a one-goal game. A lot of offense has been all Philadelphia here in the second half. They get it down to Denikin. He just puts it past Geary. Two straight goals. Look at this. The defense playing catch-up. Lob comes in late, number 7. And now it's a one-goal game, 10-9. Christy Lee.
That's the backup goalie for us. Andy, why don't you come over here and tell us exactly what happened in that huddle at halftime? Because I know that was an important one.
Quarter, unlike the first quarter where we were able to pick up the ground ball, set our offense, and start to and control the pace of the game. So we're starting to do that right now, though.
Obviously, it's working. Thank you. Backup goalie Andy Piazza. They also got to watch out for Dallas Elliott. Dallas has to step up. If doesn't, Andy will be in the game, Leaf.
Well, Philadelphia has really started off on fire here. Two quick goals inside of 2 minutes. They scored two in the first minute. As a matter of fact, now it's a power play. They go tie the game right here. Tyson Lias in the box for 2 minutes. Power play, Philadelphia. Backdoor, Denikin tries to get it past Geary, who's gone the whole way. Veltman, Shaughnessy. Here comes a fast break. 3-on-2. He gives it up to Struyer. Can't get rope. 3-on-1, and they couldn't put it home. That might come back to haunt them. They only have a slim one-goal lead right now. Over the last three games, Buffalo has scored 5 shorthanded goals against Philly. Paul Gate finds his target. Easy shot for him. It's all tied at 10.
We got
Whoa, he makes
there.
It look easy.
Got a break coming, TV break.
3 straight goals for Philadelphia. Ties it, and it's all within 2 minutes. Back up to Paul Gate. He'll just fire this rock. Look at that. Hip high. Goalie's left. A lot of velocity on that. Geary has started off very slow. Ross Cowie, as we look at Paul Gate's team, Philadelphia, they look happy. 3 goals in 2 minutes, folks.
That was after.
They are on fire. Timeout has been called.
They needed a quick break. Buffalo called it, right? Buffalo calls timeout.
Buffalo has called a timeout. We'll be back in a moment. It's all tied at 10. Philadelphia's offense is exploding.
Spring is spotting a robin in a garden of color, rejoicing in the sight of a single tulip, the bright blue of an iris. Spring is 800 flowers. Express your feelings this season with a flowering plant or spectacular arrangement. Personally chosen and lovingly designed by specially selected local florists to assure your gift is as fresh as spring itself. Call 1-800-FLOWERS today. To surprise your secretary, celebrate a spring birthday, or to make Mother's Day extra special. Spring is feeling someone's hand in yours. Seeing green instead of gray.
Across the street or across the country, celebrate now with a gift of spring flowers. Call us and we'll make all the arrangements. 800 flowers. Just call our name.
Three unanswered goals for Philadelphia. The last one by that man, Paul Gate. And now they are all locked in at 10. Dallas Elliott picks it up. Bill Geary. I think you have to start thinking about the options for Buffalo. Bill Geary, if he has a bad second half, they can go to Ross Cowie. Let's see if Bartley does that. Fast break right now, and it beats again. Geary, I wouldn't be surprised to see Ross Cowie strap on the leather.
I got the ball.
They have scored 4 goals on 4 shots in the second half. And they have stunned the crowd of the team here. Fast break transition. Buffalo just very flat, and Geary not able to save much of anything here in the second half. Now Philadelphia back in front 11-10 with a ton of time left.
Set.
He You got to give Philadelphia a lot of credit, and we do. But Buffalo seems very, very flat here in the third quarter. And Geary needs to get a couple saves to get back on his game. Here comes Paul Gate. Hard shot and a goal! They're going to have to take Geary out. I think they'll go to Ross Cowie now. Too many goals, too many shots. The whole team is letting Geary down because nobody's playing defense, nobody's getting the ball. Again, they get possession, they come down. Paul Gate right in the face, takes a shot, beats Geary, who looks unsettled. Geary's coming out of the game right now. One more look at it. He hasn't stopped much in this half. He had a great first half. Paul Gate has scored three straight goals personally. His fourth goal today, that was three straight for him. And Cowie comes into the game. You'll hear the crowd chant Cowie. Ross Cowie was the starting goalie of the season. So that is an advantage for him. He's not stepping down at all going to Ross Cowie. But Cowie needs to get warmed up. He hasn't had any warm-up. He's sitting on the sideline cold. Now comes into this game playing for the championship. First time Buffalo's been on offense in the second half, and we're already 5 minutes into the third quarter. Kilgour tries to get a shot off. He's being racked by two players. No call being made. Here comes Elliott with the outlet. It's been all Philadelphia in quarter number three, folks. Somebody has to make something happen. That'll be on Darris Kilgour. It's hard to believe they came out with a three-goal lead in the third quarter and just lost it in about 2 minutes. Here's Kilgour. Look at the offhand. Offhand pulls him down. 2 minutes on Darris Kilgour. Now the Gates game has been stepped up a lot. Paul, 4-1. The last three goals have been his. The power play is so important, I think, and the outcome of the game is starting to look better. They have a power play goal in that string of three. Paul Gate will be the point man over to Marichek. Teammates at Syracuse, winning three national championships, Paul and Geary. Down the fitter in, look for the cutting Marichek, back to Paul, hard shot, and a goal, he's got rope. He shrugs his shoulders and says, everything I throw goes in. He's almost embarrassed by the efficiency of his scoring. Four straight goals. Watch Gate after he makes this. He turns around and shrugs his shoulders. Says, what the heck? Everything I throw goes.
Keep playing.
But I talked about Ross Cowie. He was not warmed up. He was on the bench. Tough spot for Cowie. He has to get a couple saves to get loose and get warmed up. And Les Bartley's going to have to go.
Get up easy.
Hopefully he'll get up easy. Comfortable for the Buffalo and the Buffalo fans. But right now it's all Philadelphia. Six unanswered goals, and the score is 13-10. They came in with a three-goal lead, and now they're down by three. Both of these teams are very tough to play when you are down. Okay, Christy Lee.
Well, we're on the bench right now. Unbelievable. The Bandits are stunned, and we're with Paul Gate. Paul, you've had four goals quickly. What's going on?
They're just going in this half. Last half, I had a tough time shooting. Missed a lot of shots. I had some opportunities early, and they didn't go in, but now they're going in.
They definitely are going in. They're leading by three. The Philadelphia Wings bench has gone nuts. Leap. They're very excited.
Well, Christy, I can't remember, especially in a game of this importance, a turnaround, six unanswered goals in 4 minutes. That's what I can't remember. Anything that dramatic in this kind of game. Six unanswered goals, 4 minutes. Now again, Philadelphia in on Cowie. He's got rope. It's Geary this time. The Gates have taken over. They have silenced the crowd, and I tell you, Buffalo is just shocked. Here comes Geary. Makes a one quick fake. Slide is too late, and Cowie has not been settled yet. Big shot and a goal for 14 in the offensive category for Philadelphia. And the Gates have really cranked it up here in the second half. They did not have an impressive first half. We talked about that, but boy, they have done it all here in half number two. Two goals for Geary, four for Paul, seven straight goals for the team. Buffalo totally rocks. Nicola now gets the ball for Buffalo. That's a delayed call against Philadelphia. They'll have a shot. Nicola comes down. He's been a big part of the offense, scoring two or three goal games when they've needed it this year. Tavares Tavares just takes a shot to stop the clock. It'll be Gary Gates going into the box for 2 minutes.
22 holes, you're up. Keep playing, here it is.
What a turnaround. This team has come out of a cannon here in the second half. They were down by three, now they're up by four, and it's all happened inside of 6 minutes. He needs a big one here. Hamley over to Darris Kilgour. He can't find the rope. Dallas Elling has had a time to get himself together. He had a little unsettled period the second quarter, but he's been sharp. Kilgour out to Hamley with a little tricky flip, and it goes behind him. Now Cowie comes out to over and back. They lose possession. So a bad play by Kilgour gives the ball up. Buffalo will not want to lose possession here. I should say they won't want to gamble. It'll be a man down still for Philadelphia. Paul Gate comes in. Let's see if they push it now. They've got a four-goal cushion. Five players on the field for Buffalo. Only four for Philadelphia. But the Gates feel like anything they do will work. So they try to take some shots. Wraps that one around his shoulders. Cowie couldn't find it initially. Now does. Here comes Veltman. They've got over a minute left of the penalty, so still plenty of time to get a good shot. Didn't get a good shot first time at it. Chris Flynn plays the point against Veltman. Now back to Hamley. Hamley will quarterback this thing from up top. Here's Hamley right now. Over to Veltman. Hamley makes the defense respect him. Dip Kilgour takes another hard shot. Cannot get it to go. Another bad flip by Kilgour. Kilgour lost it twice. Tough flips. Hold call against Flynn. We'll go back to Buffalo. But Darris Kilgour has to take better care of the ball. He has not taken care of it on that corner. He's lost it twice in a row. 50 seconds left on the penalty. Equipment timeout for a second for Dallas Elliott. And the shots now Philadelphia has just
new
taken
shot
over
clock,
the category.
But watch your penalty clock. 22. All right, here we go, man.
Plenty of time in the penalty, 50 seconds, but right here is where they've been losing it. Kilgour has been flipping it back blindly and losing it. Hamley might shoot from there. He does, and he can't beat Elliott. Hamley again. Back, behind his back, rather, and nobody there. Finally, Tavares finds the net. You're in trouble. Here's Tavares inside of Martin. He turns around, got inside of that man down defense. Veltman knows that Martin's too far out. Tavares gets inside of Martin and beats Elliott. Major goal because it breaks that 7-goal straight streak for Philadelphia. 2 goals for Tavares today. He's been in on a lot of assists. I believe he has 3 assists. Cowie can get comfortable. Buffalo might turn around yet, but right now it's Philadelphia on a huge roll. They have taken over the game in the fourth quarter. With all that offense, though, only took them 8 minutes, so now Buffalo back on the offensive end. Veltman against Denikin. Comes in, tries to beat Dallas Elliott, can't do it. And a little bit of a skirmish between Denikin and Veltman, number 3 and number 32 for Buffalo. Big check by Tavares. He goes against Gary Gate. Now Veltman tries to get the loose ball. He was a marvel on the open field. Gets it back up. Tavares backdoor. Elias! Elias is on the back door. There he is. Big fake. Far side. Boom. Pulls it close. The rookie with a huge goal brings the Bandits back to within 14-12. There he is again. This roller coaster ride isn't over, folks. A 2-goal lead for Philadelphia. We're in the third quarter.
Think you're ready for the new La Quinta Inns?
When you walk in, you experience a beautiful focal point of
a bas-relief fountain on the wall of cast stone with a lion head spewing water.
That's an architect's description for sure.
When you enter the La Quinta lobby, you're going to get a sense of some different zones.
Zones?
You're going to have the business zone.
I'd probably like to have that fountain.
And the dining zone is for, of course, the continental breakfast.
The new La Quinta. You're not staying at a hotel. You're staying with us.
I'd like to take this lobby and stick it in my living room.
No two people are exactly alike.
Hi.
While Bob likes the high gloss shine of original Armorall Protectant, Fred prefers new low gloss Armorall with the rich, deep finish.
I gotta be me.
Either way, it's your choice. Only from Armorall.
Toss me the ball.
Ken Griffey Jr.'s always play hardball. That's why Ken Griffey Jr. presents Major League Baseball as wall-to-wall action. Only on the Super NES Sports Network. It's the one game that plays in Kinsley.
Let's see you hit.
We're back at the Odd in Buffalo. The Bandits, defending champions, being challenged by a very talented Philadelphia team who reeled off seven straight goals. They were three down coming into the half. They went up by four, but Buffalo has just scored two goals. A lot of time left, and this roller coaster ride, you got to call it, because the place is rocking now that the emotion again swings back to Buffalo. Let's see if they can maintain that momentum. Philadelphia, though, has been very impressive on the faceoffs this half. They have control on the, I think, the majority of these faceoffs. That gives them a lot of offense. Cowie makes a big save up top. Paul against Paul Gate. Gate going against two players. Feels very confident. A lot going in. Gary Martin back to Govett. He's open! He's got rope!
You got it.
Has been inside that defense twice and made a similar shot to get himself two goals in today's game. Watch all the attention up top to the gates. Now got it a wheel inside of the defensive Stu Aird. Nobody's sliding in to help. One more time, inside roll all by himself. The left-hander puts it past Cowie. 15-12, a three-goal lead. Right into the corner. They're on the field, they demand such attention. Govett and all the adjacent players can get a step on their man, and that's what they're doing. Elliott now a three-goal lead as momentum shifts again back to Philadelphia. The momentum swings in the second half have been incredible. Philadelphia, Paul Gate up top. This is Maricek. Gary Gate down low, Fittery! Takes a shot off the back of the net. He picks it back up. The shot clock still counting down. 3-2-1. Here it comes. Saved by Buffalo. Shot clock violation. And Brian Silcott, number four, will put his team down. Buffalo in the hole as Dallas Elliott came to the side to give his team an extra
Tommy's
man.
Tommy's got it. I guess it's a slash. I'm going to let you know up top. Slashing on forearm. 2 minutes.
All right, so Tamburino's got it squared away. Tommy Young made this call against Brian Silcott. It'll be 5-4 for Philadelphia. They lead by 3. Shot by Gary Gate. Paul Gate, identical twin brother, will start things up top. He's got Maricek to his left. His brother to his right. This is Fittering down low. Looks for the cutter. Maricek couldn't get it cleanly. Watch out for Paul. Shot against Darris Kilgour playing defense. Now back out to Paul Gate. Paul Gate wraps it around to Gary. Gary wraps that around for a shot off the foot of Cowie. They try to fast break it to Veltman. Veltman looks for a streaking player. It's Tavares. He can't find him. They've been off a little bit on that fast break play. Tavares came off the box, the play we showed you at the beginning of the show. They get an advantage so well, so easily on that substitution. But Dalton's pass was a little bit high. Now they're a man down, the shot clock down to 10. They talk to each other, Tavares and Dalton. Shot clock down to 3, down to 2. They're going to lose it, and they do. Christy Lee on the sideline.
Well, Lee, following that goal by Steve Govett, Tony Resch is telling his team, you guys were doing great. We needed that goal. It was really important. But there's a lot of time left. And as you can see already, we've been on quite the roller coaster here today. Anything can happen. He's stressing defense. You guys got to step up on that defense. And obviously, Dallas Elliott is having a great game.
Tony Resch, a great defensive player, now a coach. So he does like to stress the defense. That was his hallmark. Maracek comes in, gets air, but can't find the net. No rope for him. Finneran, fresh shot clock. Paulgate, rocket shot, and rope! Paulgate is taking over the game. They feel confident. They look confident. Philadelphia has reinvented the offense in the third.
Stop because you're taking extra time.
Paulgate has really been unstoppable from up top. Here it comes back up to him again. He's been taking a lot of hard shots. Veltman trying to just deflect it. One more time, it comes up to him. Just a hard, hard shot from up top, and it beats Cowie. Cowie has never had a chance really to get comfortable. One more look at it. That is the 16th goal. Now they are back to a four-goal lead, so they've wiped out the two goals that Tavares and Laya scored to try to get back into this thing. And now Buffalo, again, challenged.
If you're going to do that after every goal, big guy, let me know now while it's quiet.
Flynn picks up the faceoff. That has been a big key.
You hear me, big guy?
All the faceoffs in the third quarter.
You want to do that after every goal?
Now Philadelphia reloads the offense. Bates gets it up top. Johnny Nostrand. Hard shot by Nostrand, and the goalies for Buffalo are just not having a day.
You want a break now?
Philadelphia again scoring.
Okay,
17
here we go.
And Ross Cowie didn't get a chance to get loose, didn't get a chance to get warm. Erie had a tough start.
Give me that 15.
And they have not had good saves, not a good second half. Look at that shot. Normally Cowie comes out and gobbles that one up. Nasser with a great left hand just beats him to the far side. Philadelphia has come out so strong in the second half. Buffalo has never recovered. The first 2 minutes, inside of 2 minutes, they scored three goals. And Buffalo has been stunned ever since. Christy Lee.
We're down here on the Philadelphia Wings bench with Kevin Finneran. Kevin has been very instrumental today. Kevin, what have you done to take the Bandits out of this game in the second half?
We just came out strong, Christy, at halftime. We knew we weren't out of it. We did the run in Philadelphia and knew we could do it here in Buffalo. Getting the ground balls. Everybody's looking for open men, and we're just getting the work done.
You got to keep doing that. There's a lot of time left.
A lot of time. We're not letting down an inch.
All right. Thank you very much. Kevin Finneran, a great player in this game.
Well, Finneran and company have really exploded off the bench for the second half and have taken over the game. 2 minutes left in the third. They lead by five. They came in down by three. Buffalo needs one badly. Hamley will start up top. Takes a right-handed shot. Not his preferable side, and here comes Gary Gate. Tavares can't catch up with him. Gate, far side, watch the shot by Rogers, but a big save by Cowie. That may help Cowie. Check. That one rips the rope. Check with a real rope burner from way out front. And this is going to be a runaway, folks. 18-12, a six-goal lead.
Chop. They're taking 15 seconds after go up. Chop.
But Sheck, he was known All-American from Towson State for this kind of shooting. Look at that. Nothing to shoot at, Hardy. Just enough to get the ball in. That's all Cowie gave him. Just enough space over his left shoulder to hit the rope. And Sheck found it. Last week, this man, Rob Sheck. That's Rob Sheck, not Paul Gate. Rob Sheck had a partial separation of the shoulder, he thought, in the playoff game. But he is in this game and doing well. This is hard to believe. 18-12, Philadelphia on a huge run. And Buffalo really not getting the goalie play that they were hoping for. Hardell takes a shot out front. Flynn loses his stick and it's broke for Buffalo. And loose the follow-up shot from the crease area by Tavares. Watch it bounce up off the boards. Elliott out of position. And the redirect by Tavares gives them 13 goals. Now they're down by five. What a third quarter. Clock is rolling. And Bill Geary is back into the nets, folks. So Les Bartley has made another change in the goal. He has taken out Ross Cowie. He put Geary back in there. Cowie just didn't have a chance to get warmed up, never got comfortable against the great offense of Philadelphia. Veltman, the vacuum cleaner, comes in, trailing play. Like the Viper at Magic Mountain, this is a roller coaster ride of the best lacrosse in the world. Watch Veltman come out, look for the trailing player, Darris Kilgour. Kilgour walks in against the defense, spots his target, and hits it. Veltman, the great ground ball man, and nobody on Kilgour as he comes in. You can't fault Elliott, no defender there. Again, a transition play set up by the ground ball work of Veltman. Now they're within four. The confidence swing goes back to Buffalo a little bit. We're inside of a minute. Geary's out. Nobody in the goal. Geary gambled and lost. Great play by Billy Miller. Holy smokes.
30 seconds.
Every time they get a break, something happens. Geary gambled and lost. The ball was loose. Geary came way out of the goal. Watch Geary come from the left. He'll come up. Miss it, and that's when he got in trouble. Didn't get it cleanly. Miller came up with the ball. Stu Air tried to make the save. No match for the shooting of Billy Miller. The ball will be behind Geary. Miller picks it up, makes a fake on Stu Air. Stu Air almost got the save. Miller, the great hustle goal, takes the lead back to 5. 19-14, and there's enough scoring in this quarter to match most of the major indoor lacrosse league games. Philadelphia on a little bit of a roll. They have been up and down, both teams. Predominantly, this quarter belongs to Philadelphia. They have taken over the game. Billy Miller is down. Here comes the offense. Chris Flynn giving it off to Govert. Down to Paul Gate, who couldn't collect. Geary out of the goal again. And Miller finally gets up and goes off. Tavares gets a 2-minute penalty. As we look at Bill Geary, had a great first half, came out stone cold in the second half, first part of the third quarter. Miller was just absolutely decked back behind the goal, trailing that play. He got up, finally walked off. Miller, a member of the U.S. national team, that'll play for the U.S. and England this July. A great All-American from Hobart. So now Paul Gate and company, with 7 seconds left, they'll have a chance to get a shot if they want one. Here comes Maracek. Behind the back to Finneran. Now he stays behind. The goal goes all the way up to the quarter. But what a quarter for the offense of Philadelphia. They came into this quarter 3 goals down. They go out of this quarter 5 goals up. That has never been done before to this team in Buffalo. Ross Cowie came into the game, was cold. Was ineffective, and then he went out of the game back to Bill Geary. Bill Geary going most of the way now. Now watch the deck on Miller. Here comes the play. Tavares high over the pad into the head. And that's why Tavares will spend some time in the penalty box.
Get it moving. Keep on moving. The Silver Bullet has the taste to keep it moving. Coors Light. Naturally brewed for a taste that goes down easy. Coors Light. Keep on moving.
Back when baseball truly was the national pastime, ball players were heroes and great teams legendary. Now, Sports Illustrated brings you remarkable home movie footage of baseball's glory days. In the award-winning 2-video set, When It Was a Game. And best of all, both videos are free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated. When It Was a Game features never-before-seen home movie footage shot by the players themselves, bringing the ghosts of baseball's past to life. There's Gehrig and the Babe, Williams and DiMaggio, Ebbets Field, Fenway Park, and it's all in spectacular color. Call now and get both of these award-winning videos, along with 54 issues of Sports Illustrated, including the swimsuit issue for only $1.47 an issue. Save over 50% off the cover price. For quicker delivery, use your credit card. There's nothing like the magic of when it was a game. And there's nothing in the world like Sports Illustrated. Get into it.
All right, Elvis at the odds. A big fan of the Bandits. And they need Elvis and everybody else they can get on the squad right now. Philadelphia has taken over as the Big E entertains between the third and fourth quarter. One more stanza to go. And Heartbreak Hotel is the song he'll be singing unless they can stop Philadelphia's offense. Philadelphia owned the third quarter. 12 goals.
It up easy, fellas. It up easy.
12-4 in the third. That's a game in itself. As a matter of fact, Philadelphia lost a game about the same score to New York this season, 12-4. And that may go down as the most prolific offense in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League in any quarter. Philadelphia again gets control. That's 5-4. They have the power play to start for another minute and 30 seconds. So here goes Paul Gate with a hard shot. Bill Geary in the nets. That has been a story in itself. Dallas Elliott right there for Philadelphia has gone the whole way. But Bill Geary had a good first half, was stone cold in the second, or the early part of the third quarter. Ross Cowie came in, and it went back to Geary. Christy Lee on the Buffalo bench.
That's right, Lee. We've switched benches, and Les Bartley, the head coach of these Bandits, told him, hey, look, guys, they scored the Wings. 7 unanswered goals against us. We can score back right against them. That's what they're going to try to do. He said, you got to go out there and out-hustle, and you got to play good defense. That's what this team can do. And, of course, we all know in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League, 5 goals can mean absolutely nothing with all that time.
Well, we saw him score 5, Philadelphia, that is, in about, 4 minutes in the first part of third quarter. Now they have the power play again. Still 5-4, Philadelphia in a power play. This is Gary Gate. Down low to Dedekin. Dedekin trying to redirect it against Mrs. Finneran. Dedekin again, back door, he scores. Dedekin from Finneran for goal number 20. 6 down, Tavares leaves the penalty box. Les Bartley looks concerned, and Tavares knows that they are fighting an uphill battle. Finneran will go back door. Look, he looks away, goes back door to Dedekin, who just pokes it behind Geary. Watch Finneran look away. He'll look to his left, feed to his right, and Dedekin just slam dunks behind Geary. That power play goal, a big one. 6 goal lead now. Buffalo, their backs against the wall. Each team trying to be the first team to win 3 Major Indoor Lacrosse League titles. Buffalo would do it 3 in a row. Tavares tries to get by Martin, can't do it. Picked up by Hamley. Accordingly, this is Stu Aird. Aird coming in, being checked by Flynn. And the crowd is really out of the game at this point. Buffalo not only needs goals to get themselves moving, but they need it. Scott Gabrielson against Hamley. Scott Gabrielson takes the shot, and a big save by Geary. The crowd is flat. This crowd can really pump up the offense of the Bandits, but they need to get some offense going to ignite the crowd. There they go. Ball still in the stick, unbelievably.
Easy, Scott, fellas. Gabrielson. Keep playing or you're going to sit. Just keep playing.
Johnny Nostrand.
Let go.
Inside, big shot taken by the rookie. Now to Hamley, fast break. Can he get past Johnny Nostrand? Wraps it around his shoulder. Good shot, but a save by Elliott. Elliott looks very comfortable and confident as the fourth quarter gets to the 12-20 mark. Our live ESPN2 coverage on the mothership, on ESPN. We've had 15 games. This will be the 15th one on the deuce this year. Just wire up the deuce next year. You'll see a lot more of this action. Finneran comes in against Geary. Can't beat him. Ryan Nicola up to Tyson Lias. How many times have we seen that today? Their fast breaks are a little bit off, a little bit in front of Lias. Finneran. Watch out, Marichak. It'll stick right there. Cannot stop Marichak that close. Great fast break started with Finneran. 21-14. Outlet pass defender, and then he looks down, sees Maricek. Maricek has great stick skills. Two fakes, beat Geary. Now, it's impossible when you get this close, one-on-one, for Geary to make that save. You have to really guess. Maricek wins that battle, 21-14, and we're going up to our second page of scoring for Philadelphia. They are just exploding here at the offensive end of the field ever since the first half ended. They came out on fire in the third quarter and haven't looked back yet. Brian Hall checked by Miller from behind, and this is Gabrielson up to Nostrand. Rich Kilgour defends. Nostrand looks for a trailing player, tries to get it across, does, and there's more rope. Another goal by Maricek. This is getting to be a rout by the challenging team.
We need to roll a little quicker if we can here, big boy.
Good play by Maricek to come down the far side. They found him. He puts it home. Maricek gets his second goal in a row. And Geary, again, just not coming up to the task. If you look at the paper, Maricek's second goal today, that's really where Philadelphia has a, at least on paper, a very much of a favor in their lineup, and they have a better goalie. Statistically, that is. Cowie and Geary have been very successful, but the numbers don't add up. Paul Gates makes a save. Here comes Buffalo. That's right. Handling now. They're going to have a fight on one end. It's Kilgour against Govett. Christy Lee, what do you have on the sideline?
Leap, when I was observing the players just a few moments ago, after that Tommy Maricek goal by the wings, it was pretty much kind of one of those, oh, man, I don't know if we can do it. But these Bandits are world champions. Don't count them out. Anything can still happen, but I don't know, Leap.
Well, if I read you right, you're saying the fire has gone out of their eyes. 22-14, and if you stop believing that you can do it, that's what happens. Kilgour goes into the penalty box, so to make things even more of an impossible dream for Buffalo.
2 minutes.
They'll put Darris Kilgour in the box. It'll be 5-4 for the Philadelphia Wings. Make that a huge lead. 8-4 lead. It'll take about a 3-goal run for Buffalo to get themselves charged up enough to do what they have to do to get back in.
Keep it down!
Shaughnessy ragging Finnery behind. Finnery gets it up to Paul Gate. Gary's to his right. Crowd doesn't mind the hit. Geary Gate takes a shot, but Geary makes the big save. Puts it into the stick, and now still a man down. Buffalo will have to try to push it a little bit here. Minute 30 on the penalty.
Darris Kilgour
and
Tavares
have to go in against two players. Tries to get into the crease. He does, but a big save by Elliott. Aaron had a great shot.
You got it.
And they still continue to put pressure on Elliott. Now watch out. Tired Buffalo Bandits. There's going to be a lot of gray guys down here. Watch out. This should be a tough pressure and a shot. It is.
You got a break. You got it. TV timeout, guys. Go to your back.
Buffalo wasted a lot of energy trying to score when they were a man short. Geary saying, where's my help? Geary Gate comes down. The Gates have taken over this game. The identical twins, Super Dynamos. Fast break against the tired defensive legs of Buffalo. It's 23-14.
I can't. Well, I can't go out there. My allergies are getting worse.
But I need this job. Forget it.
Introducing a new medicine, Vince Dayquil Allergy. The anytime stuffy nose, sneezing, runny nose, itchy, watery eyes, so you can face the allergy season medicine.
Great day.
The car on the right was filled with Castrol Syntec, a synthetic oil. The other with conventional oil. They were then drained and started without oil to prove a point. You see, Syntec has a unique molecular structure that bonds to engine parts. Lab tests show it needs a layer of protection far stronger than conventional oil. And if Syntec protects this well now, imagine if you leave it in. Castrol Syntec protects in ways other oils can't.
You just spray it on.
You just spray it on.
New Quicksilver wheel cleaner from Armorall. Just spray it on, and then just spray it off.
That's it? That's it.
Quicksilver Wheel Cleaner.
Here we go.
Well, the score is unbelievable. If you saw the first half score with 9 minutes, 38 seconds to go in the fourth, the awed crowd is stunned. It's unbelievable. The runs that Philadelphia has put on in the second half have been record-breaking. And Toronto is bringing players into this area to see great offense.
Here we go. Ready?
They have seen it tonight. Philadelphia has really controlled most of the faceoffs here in the second half. They continue to do that. 23-14, and it'll be tough to come back if you don't start winning some of those faceoffs. Brian Silcott lost that one. And now here comes Chris Flynn. That's his favorite spot.
Easy, man.
Hit a shot.
Stay in the game. Stay in the game.
As he plays defense, they're all even. It's 5 against 5. Philadelphia's runs have been dramatic. Miller, far side, can't get it. Philadelphia has gone on runs of 7 straight goals, 4 straight goals, and 5 unanswered goals. Those are 3 different runs here in the second half alone. Trying to get it inside, Nikula cannot control. And again, we've seen that a lot. Buffalo just not handling it crisply like they normally do. All right, Paul, looks like Volker is down.
12.
Brian Volker, All-American defenseman from Hopkins in his collegiate days. That was off the ball. We couldn't see it.
Keep pumping. Get away. Well, unnecessary run. It's okay. He got him.
All right, the replay.
I checked with him. He agreed.
Starts with Nikula. That wasn't as bad as I thought. Left leg buckled, it looked like maybe underneath him. Volker is walking off the field, so he's okay. Well, he stayed down for a while. The hit was high and hard. 2-minute roughing call. And here comes the debris. Well, we got a converse shootout here.
It's
down. So we got a size 9.5.
You got to rock this one, 2 minutes.
Brian Nikula will come into the box for 2 minutes. The score 23-14. The Wings have taken over the game. They came into the second half down by 3. Down by 3.
Yes, I can. That's right. Keep going. Back off. I need a crew out here to clean this up. Get somebody out here to clean it up.
Tamburino not wanting this one to get out of control, but unfortunately he's got the winning team from another city.
It's 2 minutes roughing.
We'll take a commercial break. Les Bartley and his team trying to put together some kind of run to get back into this game. Right now they are down by a bundle.
A world premiere movie. He vanished without a trace, taking his brother's dreams with him. Now, 20 years later, Jake returns.
What are you going to steal from us now, Jake?
And the woman who loved them both.
I'm not some kind of pawn for you and your brother.
Must keep the family from blowing apart.
What is the matter with you?
Are you saving your farm and losing your mind?
Knott's Landing's Ted Shackelford stars in Harvest for the Heart. Tonight at 9 on the Family Channel. Now, over time, cars that can benefit from higher octane can benefit from new Clean System 3 Power Plus and Power Premium gasolines. Two choices with an advanced system of engine cleaning that works over time for the highest performance, lower emissions, and improved mileage, changing what gasoline can do. New Clean System 3 Power Plus and Power Premium from Texaco. Give us 60 days and watch what can happen.
To the Major Indoor Lacrosse League World Championship game. The Wings have taken control. They are leading by 9 goals. Johnny Nostra, Johnny, you've been in 4 championship games, 0-for-3 earlier, and of course this one's big to you. You've had 1 goal, 3 assists.
It's a good feeling, great feeling. I'll wait for the fourth. It's a great win for us. Not over yet, but looks pretty good.
All right, Johnny Nostra.
All right, back to live action. Paul Gate. The offensive Philly, watch out. Denikin backdoor. Finner cannot beat Geary. Remains in the goal. He came out for a period of time in the third quarter when he wasn't very effective. Ross Cowie could not get comfortable. So he's back in there for the duration. Paul. And Philadelphia just not letting him get that fast break transition going. 23-14, 7:40 left in the game for the North American Cup. Hamlet takes a shot, can't hit the...
Holding
call, ball goes back to the Bandits. They need a bundle, they need a lot. 23 goals, the most allowed in their playoff history. Buffalo.
That's 10! 10! 10!
Gary Gate will give it back to his brother. No, he'll take it in. His brother behind him. There it is, Paul Gate. This is their traditional setup for the 5-on-4. Down to Finneran. He fakes like he's going behind to Maracek, and Maracek cannot get it past Geary. There, a follow-up shot, and that will be a goal. They are really riddling Bill Geary. 36-year-old goaltender for Buffalo started this game, did not start most of the season, had a great last few games and got the nod today. He had a good first half, but look at the kind of pressure he's under right now. He already made two saves. This shot beats him.
We're going.
Goal number 24. They're up by 10. Paul Gate, who really had a lackluster first half. He only had one goal in the first half. He has six this half. Seven total for Paul Gate. Paul Gate scored 10 against Boston in a regular season game. Brian Hall might get called for mugging here. Mugging's not in the rule book, but that's about what he was doing. Timeout called on the floor. Brian Hall goes
okay,
to the
penalty box.
Okay,
we got a 10-minute misconduct. 10-minute misconduct on Hall. He's done for the day. And a 2-minute foul.
Brian Hall gets 10 minutes for this penalty. Right in the back of Miller. Anytime you go to the head, you're asking for trouble. Hall is gone. 10 minutes of penalties and you're off the floor in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. So thank Hall will leave. It looks like Philadelphia is marching on with confidence. We'll be back for the final 7 minutes. Stay with us.
Back when baseball truly was the national pastime, ball players were heroes and great teams legendary. Now, Sports Illustrated brings you remarkable home movie footage of baseball's glory days in the award-winning two-video set, When It Was a Game. And best of all, both videos are free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated. When It Was a Game features never-before-seen home movie footage shot by the players themselves, bringing the ghosts of baseball's past to life. There's Gehrig and the Babe, Williams and DiMaggio, Ebbets Field, Fenway Park, and it's all in spectacular color. Call now and get both of these award-winning videos, along with 54 issues of Sports Illustrated, including the swimsuit issue for only $1.47 an issue. Save over 50% off the cover price. For quicker delivery, use your credit card. There's nothing like the magic of When It Was a Game. And there's nothing in the world like Sports Illustrated. Get into it.
It goes up. That's it. No,
we're
10.
Back to the Autumn Buffalo.
Yeah, he
this
gets
is
10,
the bench of Philadelphia. Play. They were down by 3 in the first half. They have exploded offensively in the second half. And I'm telling you, they never looked back. They scored 3 goals within the first minute and a half of the third quarter and just have dominated the defending champion, Buffalo Bandits. It's 24-14, and now they are still in the power play. Major penalty to Brian Hall. This is Finneran now playing up top. They move Gary Gate down low. There's a hard shot by Denikin. He finds the corner. That'll be Rope and the 25th goal. We're starting to make records here. And now 11-goal lead for Philadelphia. Finneran gets it all the way across. Maracek down
don't
the line.
That
there's Gary Gate
don't
down low. So Bresch is experimenting with that extra man unit. Has been very, very effective in the second half. You've got a chance to see some of these stars.
We're going.
Denikin knocks one home. Paul Denikin, 4 goals today. He has been very effective against Buffalo throughout the history of this matchup, Philadelphia against Buffalo. Geary still in the goal, picked up by Chris Flynn. The reign of the Buffalo Bandits looks like it's coming to an end. Philadelphia, a commanding lead. Ryan Nicola. Being defensed by Martin.
2-minute hold.
They're going to call Gary Martin on a 2-minute hold. Nicola came in, had a little spin move, rolled back to the outside. Martin used both his stick hand and his offhand to wrap him up. That'll give him 2 minutes in the box.
Holding 2 minutes.
So a power play. We haven't seen many of these for Buffalo. No goal
okay,
scored so far.
We'll watch for it. Okay, I understand. Okay, we'll watch for it.
They really haven't scored since late.
Back court, boy.
So it's been about 11, 12 minutes. Shot by Darris Kilgour very early in the power play. They know they need a lot of goals, and they don't have that much time, so they've got to take some shots. Veltman on the far side, big save by Elliott. And Tavares nails Billy Miller. Well, I don't want to throw Tavares out of the game because I think the 16,000 folks here might react violently, to tell you the truth. This is their hero, John Tavares, number 11. Accordingly, one of the young stars rising in this league. Watch Billy Miller, number 99. He gets nailed by Johnny Tavares. Really wasn't a bad hit. If you're on the ball, it's a good hit.
Number 11, 5 minutes.
He's getting a five-minute major penalty.
5 minute foul. Five.
So now Tavares goes to the penalty box.
5 minute foul.
Philadelphia has a chance to add to this lead. Not a glamorous way for the defending world champions to go out. They're a little frustrated. They came into the league 2 years ago, lost their first three games, then proceeded to win every game that remained and win the championship. The following year, last year, they went undefeated and won it again. This year, they had two losses during the regular season, but are being challenged here and overtaken by a very talented Philadelphia Wings team. Ball Gate and Nostrand working the power play. This is Maracek. Jim Veltman now on him. So the five-minute major looks like it's still 4-on-4. No power play here, really. It's 4, and that's an easy goal on Paul Gate. He can do no wrong.
Now it's one goal, right.
So the five-minute major to John Tavares will not bring him back on the field. You need two goals to release the penalty. Watch him come right in. Paul Gate can really do no wrong. He comes in, takes a shot. This is the Michael Jordan of this league, folks. He has all the tools, all the skills, and he has an identical brother, an identical twin that has skills like his. Eighth goal today, Paul Gate, after
scoring
one in the first half. So he has seven this half.
Right. So you, that's what we're trying to do.
And Paul Gate, if you want to know what the best skills of the game look like, you're seeing it right here. He is the best, along with Gary. Gary actually had better numbers in the field game at Syracuse, but Paul shines in the box arena. 4:30 left in this one.
Holding this way.
And he'll give it to Buffalo. Les Bartley talked to Rich Tamburino moments ago and said, let that clock run. It's getting very ugly. Let's get these guys off the floor. He concedes that the outcome is pretty much decided. 12-goal difference. Hard to believe.
Keep that clock going.
And don't forget that Buffalo had a 3-goal advantage in the first half. Gary Gate goes to Nostrand, back to Gary. Between the legs, 5-hole shot. Gary Ryan Nicula tries to find Stu Aird. Aird can't pick it up cleanly. Govett. Nostrand. I don't want to put Michael French, general manager of Philadelphia, on the spot, but he predicted in his own proud way that it could be a blowout for his Philadelphia team. That was a bold prediction before this game started, but now he looks pretty accurate. 3:33 left. Philadelphia having it all their way, as the crowd here just can't believe that not only are the Buffalo Bandits going to lose the North American Cup, but they are getting shellacked by this great team from Philadelphia. Maracek's hit one around, wraps it around his shoulder, and it's a save by Gary. Here's the outlet. Christy Lee on the sideline.
Well, Lee, we're down here on the Philadelphia Wings bench, and I can tell you, as Chris Flynn said just a few moments ago, this is so sweet. And for the captain of the Wings, you've got to feel the same way, Scott Gabrielson.
This is so sweet. We've been waiting all year for this. Since last April, when we lost to these guys by one goal, we've been waiting all year for this, and this really shows how resilient we've been to come through and win as big as we did. We were down by 3 at halftime. We came back on fire, and this is great. This is so sweet.
What were the magic words at halftime?
We knew that what we had to do. We played a little lackadaisical. We had a few bad goals, but we came out with fire. We want this. We want it. Revenge.
And it shows. Scott Gabrielson, captain of the Philadelphia Wings, and looks like the new major indoor lacrosse. lacrosse league champions.
It'll be their third ring. Before this game, only one guy on this field had three rings, and that's assistant coach Peter Crawford. He has two from Buffalo, and he was with Detroit when they won the national or the world championship. So he has three rings that will now tie the Philadelphia squad, the players that have played in all three of those. Dallas Elliott has gone the whole way, has looked good, had one little bit suspect time in the second quarter where he was getting rocked pretty well, but he stayed with it. He comes up big as a first team All-Pro. Veteran, in no hurry. During the course of the season, there's a shot by Rogers, a save by Geary. They each played each other once here in Buffalo, once in Philadelphia, and each team won their home game by four goals. So everybody expected this would be close. Before those two four-goal wins, each in their home arena, these two teams played to a one-goal decision the last three times. So a close game was expected. This is a shocker, and a proud Philadelphia waits for their champions to come home.
Yeah, let's just keep going, big guy. Easy!
1 minute now. Geary makes another save. Outlet pass Lau, but no, he goes to the far side to Rich Kilgour. Philadelphia on the strength of a third quarter explosion. They came out in the second half and just lit it up. Scored three goals in the first minute and a half. Shot by Nicula does not find the net. Finally, some rope. Tyson Lyons and company finally get a goal on the boards. That's their first goal in the fourth quarter, I believe. First goal in the fourth quarter. They went 15 minutes without a goal. Lyons gets the rebound and just finally puts it past Elliott. Tyson Lyons, who almost didn't make it this far because of the injury to his hip in the first half. 26-15.
You still got time on a penalty.
Derek Laub has to go off.
Go ahead, Tommy.
As they face off.
No. You still got 5 seconds on it. I got it.
Trying to do a little housekeeping. I don't think it's going to work. This place will get a little bit dirtier as the clock winds down. Let's just get it rolling, guys. Lee Felsmo and Christy Lee, our ESPN2 coverage of major indoor lacrosse league action on the mothership, ESPN. Lias tried to get that, cannot collect it. Philadelphia with an unbelievably comfortable win. Veltman tried to get the final goal, can't get it. Tavares cannot find that feed. Silcott. As the clock winds down of this season, takes a shot. Elliott very comfortably picks it up. And that should do it. It's hard to believe it. The Philadelphia Wings become the new winners of the North American Cup and the world champions of major indoor lacrosse. No big cheers for Philadelphia, but they are back in Pennsylvania. They've got a fanatical following at the Spectrum. Buffalo's string of two straight ends. Philadelphia wins the new world championship. The final score, 26-15. We'll be back.
You guys getting this? Huh? Is this great or what? Just me and the great one. Nice pass, Gretz.
I'm gonna be showing this to my grandkids. My grandkids' kids. Who am I kidding? I'm gonna be watching this on a loop in my own house with my friends, charge a buck for every guy. You know what? Not as big as I thought he was. I think I could take him.
Nice pass, Gretz. Yeah.
Wayne, that last pass a little bit outside.
I'll work on it.
Well, the Philadelphia Wings have won the major indoor lacrosse world championship, beating the Buffalo Bandits 26-15 and spending
championship so bad, they lost 2 years in a row by one goal apiece each year. And I can tell you, folks, there is not a happier group of guys.
The first time in a long time for me to win it. I said it to you at the beginning of the year. At 90 was the last time, and it feels great. We went in the locker room, and we had a great talk, and we weren't even scared. We were down by 3 goals, but it didn't bother us for 1 second. We knew that we had the athletes on the team to pull it through.
Obviously, it didn't bother you. Congratulations, Tommy Marichek, and your Philadelphia Wings.
Thank you very much.
Oh, you're welcome. There'll be some celebrating in the Philadelphia Wings locker room, and we will be back to recap everything here at the Odd in just a second. So please stay with us. There's nothing like a win for the Wings, huh? They're enjoying it.
Back when baseball truly was the national pastime, ball players were heroes and great teams legendary. Now, Sports Illustrated brings you remarkable home movie footage of baseball's glory days in the award-winning 2-video set, When It Was a Game. And best of all, both videos are free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated. When It Was a Game features never-before-seen home movie footage shot by the players themselves, bringing the ghosts of baseball's past to life. There's Gehrig and the Babe, Williams and DiMaggio, Ebbets Field, Fenway Park, and it's all in spectacular color. Call now and get both of these award-winning videos, along with 54 issues of Sports Illustrated, including the swimsuit issue for only $1.47 an issue. Save over 50% off the cover price. For quicker delivery, use your credit card. There's nothing like the magic of When It Was a Game. And there's nothing in the world like Sports Illustrated. Get into it.
Everybody knows the garden has a history of the lights going out, but I'll let you on a little secret why.
Major Indoor Lacrosse League World Championship game on ESPN has been brought to you by Coors Light. Great game, great beer, indoor lacrosse, and Coors Light. By Adidas, the official footwear of the MILL. Adidas, the brand with three stripes. By Brian Lacrosse Equipment, official equipment supplier to the MILL and Buffalo Bandits. And by SPX Lacrosse Equipment, official equipment supplier to the MILL and Philadelphia Wings.
Well, what a surprise game. Philadelphia wins. That's not as much a surprise as the score. They exploded in the second half. Leif Elsmoe, Christy Lee winding up a very successful year on ESPN2's coverage of the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. Now, we're on the mothership tonight, but every Monday night during the season, we had this kind of action, and it was a fabulous year.
It sure was. I'll tell you, Leif, I have never seen a game like this one. And at the first half, it was so close. It was amazing. I really thought the Bandits were going to do a three-peat here in Buffalo, but the Wings didn't let him get it down, and here they are, new world champions.
You know, Mike French, I talked about that. He came up and predicted it could be a blowout. He had confidence in his team. Buffalo always finds a way to win. And the fans here are doing some
not very happy about
things.
It, yeah.
They love their team here in Buffalo. But today, it's all the Philadelphia Wings story as they get their third
before Roberto Kelly breaks it up. We'll be back with more of the postgame show after this.